not already know. We do shows for absolute beginners, so if you've never picked up a sewing needle before, then welcome. If you're like, I don't want to call you an intermediate, but if you've done a bit and you want to refresh yourself, welcome. If you want the best quilters in the world, welcome. It is open for everybody. This is your sewing quarter. Now, you can get in touch, right? This is important because we want it to be interactive. So if you want to ask me a question, or more importantly, you want to ask the designers a question, then you can do it. And the best way to do it is go to the website, right? www.sewingquarter.com. There's me saying hello. What you need to do is go to the just click on watch the live show. You press on that, you'll get a bigger screen, and sadly I'm even bigger on that screen, so you can watch us there right now. If you want to send a message, just scroll down like producer Hannah is doing now, and you see the box says message the studio. You just write a message in there. What am I getting today? Oh, just hello today. I got hello Joe last week. So that's that. But I also need to tell you on that page, if you want to buy something, you just, well, we're going the other way. Okay, go upwards. You see, if you want to buy something, you just press add to your basket there. So you just click on there and that pops in your basket. As long as you check out by midnight, one P&P for the whole day of £2.95. Or if you do what Hannah was just doing, scroll down the page, you will see, now there are all the things from yesterday. As the shows go on today, everything that we show you will be on that shopping list. So you can pop in and have a look. If you think you've missed something, or you can't remember the item code number for it, or something like that, just go along there and you can see everything. That's all of yesterday's. In a minute, when we start the show, all of today's pieces will come on. That's the second way you can get in touch as well. If you don't want to do the web chat, you can just email us, which is studio@sewingquarter.com. studio@sewingquarter.com. Right, better get on, because we are inspired by animals today. So all the pieces today will have some inspiration to do with animals, starting off with the gorgeous Sammy Claridge. Why my little friends here is we're going to show you little applique. Gorgeous applique. Isn't that? It's Tilda. That is just lovely, isn't it? But let me go over and we'll meet Sammy. You've already met Sammy, but see Sammy and we'll talk more about that later. Good morning, my lovely. How are you?
I'm very good, thank you.
Oh, come here. Right, so now, I've never seen these, because to me, when I trained, right, applique was, you drew a picture, you cut it out, you did the fabric, but these are lovely little kits that you can get, aren't they?
Yeah, they pre-cut the shapes for you, and it's a bit like, if you're watching the show, the English paper piecing, so they're firm enough that you can wrap your fabric around, and then you remove the paper afterwards.
Okay, so this is how it actually comes. Let me show the instructions out there. This is how it actually comes to you. It's, I mean, fabulous, really, really lovely as a gift idea. They're from Tilda. They're Bumblebee Paper Piece Applique from the Bumblebee range by Tilda. And there's the little shapes there, and they're gorgeous, aren't they? Now, I have got two. We'll talk about the bumblebees, but I've also got... So they call them dragonflies. Is she calling the other ones dragonflies?
Yes.
We've got dragonflies as well, but we're just concentrating on the bumblebees. So this little kit here is £5.95. Now, what do you get in that kit then?
So you get your instructions. So this is basic instructions of how to use them.
Right.
The paper shapes, and then you get the paper shapes that have been pre-cut for you.
Oh, okay, brilliant.
You get loads.
Loads. You get loads. Are they sticky then?
No, they're not sticky. They're just cardboard, but they're a really nice weight of cardboard, so that obviously because you've got nice small shapes, they're really sturdy so that you can, get really nice crisp folds.
I'll just show you these. So you've got the bumblebee body there, and you've got the bumblebee wings. So you could choose which fabrics to do them out of, couldn't you, really? You see, that's the body. Bumblebee body there, and that's the thing. I'll show you, because I'll just get this picture for you, because I've got it here. These are they, aren't they?
They are.
Oh, now are there different sizes?
Yes, you get two different sizes, large and small, in this packet. I think it's the same with the dragonflies. And then, these are done, I did these with the wings attached, so they're all one colour.
Yeah.
But you can, like we've done on the shirt, use two different fabrics for each of the...
Okay, so I'll move that picture to one side. Now, we're loving this fabric. Just to explain what it is, this is a charm pack that you've used, haven't you, to create these bumblebees.
Used these. They're gorgeous. Really good for applique, because you get loads of different prints.
Well, I'm just going to take this off, and I'm just going to show you all the... I'll go through it properly later. But there are so many gorgeous prints in here, aren't there? Now, you get two of each. Oh, I love that one. I love that one. This is the newest collection, isn't it, from Tilda, this one, yeah. The bumblebee. Yeah. Oh, look, I'll go through it all properly with you later. Little bumblebees in that one there. Can you see? Aren't they lovely? Love this. Love this. Very William Morris. Very William Morris, isn't it? They've all got the... It's called the bumblebee range for a reason. Most of them have got bumblebees drawn on them. That one there, that's beautiful. Excuse me, isn't it? That is such a gorgeous design. But remember, you get two of these. Now, remember, charm packs, they are 5 inches square, aren't they? That's right. Oh, look at that. How beautiful is that? So what you're getting in this charm pack is 2 pieces of all... That's lovely, isn't it? Of all the collection. I'm saying I'm going to go through it later. I'm going through it all now because I love it so much. Oh, I'm intrigued now. Hang on, I've got 2 stuck together there. Oh, there we go. Oh, that's nice. I love that one. They're like pagodas. I called them orange, the orangeries the other day, didn't I?
Reminds
like,
me
oh,
of them.
That's
plates.
Nice.
The what, sorry? It reminds me of that plate pattern, the blue and white.
Oh, yes.
Gorgeously citrus.
Aren't they all? And look at the little bumblebees on there. Yeah. The whole collection. It's just gorgeous. Lazy summer days, that's exactly what it's saying to me, isn't it? I love this one as well, because I love the fact it's got gingham behind the flower. Really, really contemporary, that one. I mean, you could, the Tilda fabrics are just beautiful, aren't they? I could go on and on. In fact, I am. I'm going to finish the whole pack now. Look. How that is beautiful, isn't it? Absolutely. Oh, I've got the shakes this morning. I'm not sure why. You're making me nervous.
Coffee.
No coffee this morning. Really, really beautiful. Down to the end there, last couple of bumblebees. I will go through that. Oh, look. I will go through all of that again for you in a second. They are amazing. Oh, sorry, taking it completely out of shot there. Amazing for your applique. So, shall we start? Because what people are doing is they're tuning in to see you and your expertise.
Yeah.
So I'll let you get on. Before you do, I'm just going to ask about the instructions.
Yes.
I mean, they come in the pack, but there seems to be an awful lot of instructions.
Yes,
there.
They are in different languages,
oh, okay.
But it's not that complicated. You get 1 page of UK instructions and then a nice pictorial arrangement situation as well, so
uh-huh.
You can kind of give you some ideas of how to arrange them. But yeah, the English instructions are nice and clear, very straightforward, easy to follow.
I'll just show you those then. They come in the pack. There we go. Well, let's turn it around.
There we are. There's a basic how to do it pictorial version as well.
Right. All the paper piece applique, the instructions there. I mean, you've got 2 pages. You've got 2 pages there. And they're clear, aren't they? Clear
yeah,
and simple.
Yeah, absolutely. Because obviously you've got the picture version, but then obviously you've got a written explanation if you prefer that kind of thing.
Perfect. So let's start.
Lovely.
At the very beginning, as Julie Andrews once said.
I'm going to grab my favourite new thing.
Oh, yes.
In the world. It's this glue pen. You can tell because I've been using it a lot. It is absolutely gummed up at the top.
Okay. Now, how does this work then? You're going to glue something to... Are you going to glue that to fabric?
I'm going to glue it to fabric, yeah.
Oh. Now, I've got that pen and the refills here.
These are great, particularly because we're working with something so tiny.
Right.
You know, these bits are quite small.
I'll let you do this first, and then I'll explain the pen.
And obviously, the problem with... Normally, you would have to stitch this around, you know, and gather it in and make sure everything... But obviously, the glue pen takes all that worry away. I'm just going to do this shape, because I like this one, because of the way that you can put it up to kind of create the pieces of the bumblebee.
Oh, yes.
Does that make sense? So
yes.
I'm going to line it up like that. That's fine.
So, do you leave the cardboard in then?
Depending on what you're doing with it, for where I did the framed one, I've left the cardboard in.
Yes.
On the shirt, we've taken the cardboard out because obviously that's going to be washed.
Of course.
So we don't want to leave the cardboard in because it'll get all soggy in the
wash. Yes, of course. But I'm just worried about the glue. So the glue... You can get rid of the glue then.
Yeah,
the
glue is
off.
It's a wash away.
Oh, okay.
So it'll wash away, but also obviously I'm putting it on and it's blue, but it dries completely clear. It's just blue, so you can see where you've put it.
Okay, let me just explain. So if you've already got the glue pen, then you can get refills, right? We've got the. Now we've been showing a lot of applique recently. There we go. That one there is the refill blue. Contains 2. Blue, oh, £2.45, that's brilliant. And you said they last a long time.
They do. I mean, I managed to do the whole... I did a 75-piece hexagon thing the other day, and
yes.
I kind of just almost ran out, and then I got to do a couple more, so they last a long time.
So there are your refills. If you want the pen as well, we've got the pen here as well. That's the graphics at the bottom of your screen there. The Soline water-soluble glue stick and blue refill for £5.95. Now, We've reordered and reordered this because you've loved this pen so much and the refill so much. Anyway, I'll let Sammy get on.
I love them. I love these glue pens. I had never used them before. I was always very much a sewer when it came to, you know, paper piecing. And they sent me this and I was like, I'm not sure. Gluing makes me feel a bit funny sometimes.
Yes.
Because I'm a sewer, you know, a sewer. So, but this, for what you use it for and the fact that it disappears and you can peel it away so easily, means that it's a really, A, time saving and B, really good for these little small fiddly shapes.
Of course.
Really amazing.
So, can you do one again in case anybody missed you doing that one?
Let's do the smaller one as well at the same time.
So, you just take your. Cardboard
so you just
shape.
Take your cardboard shape. I like to pop a little bit of glue on there to keep it in place. And then I'll just pop her down. So that's just going to hold it whilst I cut around.
So now you just use normal scissors?
I'm just using normal scissors because I'm not... The applique scissors, which we're going to use later...
Yes.
They've got a duck bill for a particular reason.
Oh, OK.
To help lift the layer of fabric. Fabrics apart so that you don't snip through the layer underneath. So for just cutting out shapes, you don't need to use the applique.
They're nice rose gold. Because you love rose gold, don't you?
We
had your laptop in the other day, didn't we? When we made the laptop cover.
Yeah.
That's rose gold.
And my phone's rose gold as well.
But none of your jewellery is?
No. Funny, I'm a silver person when it comes to jewellery.
Okay, so we've stuck that on and you've cut. Now, you've cut how much seam allowance or how much allowance have you left around?
Depending on the shape of the size of the piece. Obviously, these are slightly bigger pieces. When we're doing these, we're going to use slightly smaller pieces because we've got little tiny folds here.
Yes.
It's not too accurate, kind of just under a centimetre, probably.
Right.
And then I'm going to go in and snip away because we're going to fold these edges over. So where we've got really tight curves in the body, we're going to cut a V.
So any like notches in the shape of the bee or whatever it is, or the dragonfly, you're just cutting a little V there.
Just to take the bulk away, because obviously we're going to fold these over to the back and again glue them in place, and we don't want too much bulk on the back.
Oh, I see. So the glue's not just for putting the cardboard on the fabric, you're actually going to use it to do all the folding over. Oh,
yeah.
I see.
And then around the rest of it, we're just going to snip. And I like to not go too close in.
No.
It's, again, just to reduce that bowl. You can V all the way around if you like. I don't find it's totally necessary because this is not very thick fabric.
Okay. I'll just let you do that and then I'll give it a...
You can show.
Show off. So you go all the way around with everything.
Yep.
So we've taken the notches out of where the... indents are, but then everywhere else you've actually almost done like a fringe, really, haven't you, around the outside, but not going too close to the actual piece of cardboard.
No, because what happens if you go too close, if you snip too close to the piece of cardboard, when you fold it over, you end up with little tufty bits fluff hanging out the side, and we don't want fluff hanging out.
And also, this cotton is so beautiful. It's going to be very malleable as you take it folded
around. You get really crisp folds. It's really nice. So I'm going to do this one at the same time.
Okay, it's the quality of the Tilda fabrics, you see. That's what... The joy of doing something like this, because you know they're going to work with you. They're going to press nicely, they're going to fold nicely and everything like
that.
The
dainty prints work beautifully as well, because you're dealing, again, with really small shapes, particularly with the dragonflies, which are even more dainty. You do have to have the small prints and obviously the lighter weight fabric, you know, that's easily fold overable. But you still get, because it's cotton, you still get that really crisp finish when you give them a quick iron. Just snipping all the way around. Okay.
I'm just going to get, because we keep talking about the dragonflies. Keep chatting. I'll just go and get the dragonfly pack because it's the same effect, really, isn't it?
Yeah, just same theory. Same just principle. You have obviously the bigger wings and then the slightly skinnier body.
Okay, that'll come across the bottom. If you don't want the bumblebee and you want the dragonfly, there it is. Dragonfly paper piece applique from Bumblebee, £5.95. Again, you get loads in there, don't you?
You get 200 pieces in the dragonfly, 180 pieces, because obviously you've got more wings going on with the dragonfly, 180 pieces in
there. That's fantastic. You can use it for lots of things. I mean, we're showing you... Well, no, let's carry on with the applique and then I'll...
But, yes, you can. You can use them as templates as well. So now we're going to fold the edges over...
Right.
To the back side, like we would if we were doing a hexie or any kind of English paper piecing.
Oh, OK. I haven't done a paper piecing show with you yet. Oh,
of course you haven't.
Now, you see, when I learnt how to do applique, we had to, like you were saying earlier, we stitched it. We did a drawstring... No, not a drawstring, I'll start again. Gathering thread.
Yes.
Pulled it in tighter and then fold it over, and it was all about working it with the iron. Whereas
yes.
this... The heat from your finger, you can almost finger press it over.
Yes, I mean, there are also little tools you can get that help you to pull that over. I've seen the metal ones on the internet, but I like to use my finger because I feel like I've got more control
yes.
Over where it's going to go. And also, obviously, curving in, because these shapes curve in and out.
Yes.
I feel like I can get into those curves a bit better
yes.
with my fingers. I can push against the edge of the mat.
You don't need it, because we sell a little mini iron here. You wouldn't need the mini iron at this stage. I mean, that'd be quite good if you want to get pressed down solid.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. I mean, I don't have a little. I've got a small iron. It's
yeah.
like a travel iron, but not a mini. One of those.
Oh,
mini
we have
irons.
A mini iron, £49 and
95 pence. They're so helpful. I particularly think for this again because we're dealing with really tiny, small shapes. And again, lots of curves.
I imagine this would be, I mean, I know all sewing, hobby sewing things are very therapeutic, but this, I'd find this really therapeutic, just folding that over and making the shape.
Yeah, again, it's something that you can do kind of anywhere.
Yeah.
Because it's small pieces and it's kind of hand sewing, not big machine sewing, and you can prep a lot of
yes,
it.
Exactly.
Just sitting down in front of the TV, it doesn't take a lot of concentration.
Yeah.
And then the next stage, obviously, with the hand sewing, then you can sit and do, you know, in your own time.
Okay. Oh, we had a couple of messages already. Thank you, very, thank you.
Early this morning?
Gracie has asked, could she use pinking shears to cut round that edge there?
Yes, absolutely, you can. Yeah, no reason why not.
But I suppose the glue stops it from fraying anyway, does it not?
Yeah, although we're obviously going to peel the paper
yes.
out afterwards, so yes, pinking shears would work.
Yes, Gracie,
perfectly
fantastic
well.
Question, thank
yeah.
you. Linda would like to know.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Linda's loving the new channel. Thank you, Linda,
oh,
my
thanks,
love.
Oh, thanks, Linda. There we go.
She's been watching from the first day since we've launched.
Oh, bless.
Oh, Linda, thank you. She's got a soft spot for me. Linda, thank you so much.
Me too.
Oh, Samantha has texted in or messaged in saying, I love your shirt. It's Pugalicious, John. Thank you very much
Pugalicious.
Indeed. It's animal-inspired day, isn't it? You see, I had to wear my pug shirt today,
it
didn't
is.
I?
It's amazing.
Thank you very much for your lovely messages. Thank you. Right, so...
So you can see I've worked my way around there and some of them will stick up a little bit because obviously they're going down over fabric. So just pop a little bit of glue on the underside there and then just stick it down. It sticks fabric to fabric as well as to paper.
Yes.
You don't have to worry about all them sticking down all the way around, but then you can see that's what it is going to look like.
But it looks incredibly neat, doesn't it?
On
What's
the
it look
side?
Like from the other side?
From the other side, it looks like a floral covered
It looks like a bumblebee body, that,
yes.
doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
Timothy's loving this, because Timothy's our director. He doesn't get out very much these days. And he said he's sitting at home on his own most nights watching the telly, so he'd love to... He might do this.
I must admit, particularly with the glue stick, it is quite therapeutic.
The thing is, this is the kind of thing that I would get completely hooked on.
Yeah.
And I'd want to make more and more and more and more, you know what I mean? It's like years and years ago when I worked for the Royal Ballet, and if they needed the... bodices beading,
mm-hmm.
they give them to me because they knew that I could sit in front of the telly beading
that you'd love
away
it.
And what you know, kind of, I just love things like that.
I always wanted to work on Strictly Come Dancing, but be the person who does the gemstones.
Yes, yes, yeah.
Because I used to do that when I was younger.
Ah, right.
And I was like, I'd have a job on Strictly just because they just employ me just to put rhinestones on things all day long. I love it. I'm quite an impatient sewer. I mean, I think I am. People would probably disagree, but I love doing like little
yes,
tiny things
yeah.
that take ages that most people go.
It's so satisfying as well when you finish this,
yeah,
isn't it? It's
absolutely.
Really satisfying. Yes, I do. I used to love doing beading and things like that. In fact, with Stephen Adnett, the costume designer on Strictly when you were there, he used to be one that I used to work with at LWT years ago. So we're carrying on round the edge.
Yeah, and again, if you need to pick it up at any point, some of these bits are very fiddly, so I find that picking it up rather than putting it down,
yes.
just so that you can kind of get all the way around from underneath and just smoothing your finger over those edges. Again, that's the thing I love about these Tilda shapes, is because they're made of card, As opposed to sometimes if you're doing applique, they're just made of very thin paper, yeah, or even freezer paper or interfacing. It's hard to get that fold over.
Yes.
Because obviously you've not got anything to resist that fold over. So the fact that these are made of a slightly thicker cardboard.
So now, can you reuse them?
Absolutely. Yeah, again, because of the quality of the pieces in here, because they are made of cardboard as opposed to flimsy paper, you, once you peel them out, as long as you peel them out carefully.
So your £5.95 is not just going to be a one-off one.
No,
you can
absolutely
keep, put them back in the box and use them over and over
and
over again.
Like I said, obviously, because we've left them in the picture, you could have I could have taken them out. I could have cut behind, which is what we're going to do, show you the technique, but later, of how to remove them. You can take them out, reuse them loads of times. You can trace around them if you want to. If you want to do machine applique rather than hand applique, you can just use them to trace around. Again, because they're sturdy, you can trace around them.
Oh, so that's what you were saying earlier. You could use them as a template. So you could
draw
around it on the back of your fabric if you're going to do machine stitching through.
Yeah. Yeah, so you could do satin stitch around the edge and not have to worry about folding under if you're... if you like the shape, but you're not keen on the idea of having to do all the fold over.
Exactly, exactly.
I mean, this is the bit I like, this kind of fiddly bit that seems to take ages. Sorry.
No, it's good. It's good.
We've got plenty of time.
I've got a message from Jane now. She's loving the show. Oh, great information.
Thanks.
Oh, she says the glue pens are a godsend.
They are. They are, particularly for this dainty paper piecing.
What else have you used them for, then? I'd like to know, if they're a godsend, what else do you use them for? That's what I'd like to know.
Someone said the other day she used them for tacking, so just general tacking and sewing. Yeah. And I must admit, I have done, on the bit that I'm going to show you in a minute, I have used it to just tack these in place, so I know where they're going to go.
These are obviously the refills here. These are the refills. So we know a lot of you bought the pen from us last week. But you see, these are the blue pens. So do we do different colours, then? There's a yellow one as well. There's a yellow one as well, but that's the blue one I'm showing you there. But as you say, it dries, even though it's blue, it dries clear.
It dries completely clear, which I'll show you in a minute, because I'll unwrap one of these and show you.
Tap it, unwrap it. Oh, no, that's a chocolate bar, isn't it? So I thought I was going to come up with a phrase then, but that's already been used.
OK, so that's what they look like when they're done. Let me hold both those up so you can see how gorgeous they look.
You're not doing any wings, then?
Not for these ones, no, because we've got them over here ready done.
Oh, you've done them already. OK. I suppose what you could do as well is you could use the gorgeous bumblebee Tilda fabric for the bodies, and if you wanted to, you could get like a chiffon or a twinkle chiffon or an organza to make the wings out of.
Yes, absolutely. Or you could, if you were new and you felt these pieces were too small, why not just embroider?
Yes.
Around, you know, or, you know, do a little bit of hand stitching around to make the wing shape and maybe put some veins in there.
It's only 8:25. We're coming up with lots of creative ideas so far this morning. Okay, so what's the next stage?
So the next stage would be to decide, obviously, what you're going to put them onto.
Yes.
We've done the shirt. I've done the shirt and the thing.
There's a blanket somewhere as well.
There is. This is the blanket here. Let me show you.
I'll just show you all the different ideas here. That's beautiful. Look at that on the corner of the blanket there. I mean, you can make something completely... You could get a baby blanket, but make it completely individual.
Well, this was a blanket from a second-hand shop.
Oh, you didn't make it yourself?
No, I didn't make it myself.
I thought it looked like your stitching.
Well, I could have, but I was in a hurry. and I wanted to spend time doing the applique.
Of course.
And, yeah, just put that in the corner. How much, you know, how much more does, you know, special
personal
does that look
does it make
now?
It, yes. And then also, I love this. I love the... Because it's just a simple way of doing decoration in a what could be a dull room. You just liven it up, couldn't you?
And also, if you've used the fabric somewhere else in the room... quite often with interior design, they say about the rule of three. So if you're introducing a bright colour or, you know, a pop of colour, you have to put it three places in the room to kind of make it a thing rather than just a random colour thing in the thing. You know, put it in a frame, put it on the blanket and put it on the cushion.
Put it on your blouse that you're wearing
exactly.
On that day.
Yeah. So then
exactly.
You've got
exactly. So let's move on. Remember all the fabric. Oh look, isn't that lovely? All the fabrics we're using are from this bumblebee charm pack that I was showing you earlier at £17.95 for. Remember, charm packs five. I don't need to tell you. 5-inch squares. You get two of each fabric.
So this is what, in theory, it will look like when you've finished putting all your pieces. And I've just used the glue pen just to kind of tack these in place.
Okay. So
because obviously I wanted to get like a a particular pattern, and obviously we wanted to get all the wings in the right place, yes, with the right ones and everything. And obviously this looked like a big pile of mess when I was doing them because they didn't.
So you've stuck all of the pieces, the wings and the bodies. They've still got the cardboards inside them
at the moment. Those? Yes, because what we're going to do is we're going to hand stitch.
Oh, that one's already been done there.
This is stitched, yes, and the paper's been taken out, and I'll show you that in a moment.
Oh, brilliant!
But just wanted to show you the next step, which would be hand sewing it.
Yes, okay.
All the way around. And I wanted to show particularly how, because it's quite dangerous, because people say, oh, how do you do that and not see the stitching?
No.
So I wanted to show that little bit of hand sewing.
It looks like a little bit of magic. Where's my glasses? Oh, tell me, I've come to work without my glasses.
Oh, no.
Beautiful, beautifully done. I'll get Jay to get them for me. I must have left them in my dressing room. I had them earlier because we had a meeting and I wrote things down, so
they're probably on your desk outside.
Yeah, they'll be on my desk out there or they'll be in my dressing room, one of the two. Anyway, so while you, I'm going to let you show us how to do that.
Then. Sure, I'm going to do this again because Natasha thought this was funny the other day when I did it, so I thought I'd show it again. Is how I do a knot in the end of thread.
Oh, okay.
That sounds ridiculous, but she said it was special, so I thought I'd show it again. As I've got a darker top on today, you can probably see a bit better.
Okay.
I take the end of the thread,
yeah,
wrap it around my finger,
right,
and then twist it off the end of my finger and pull it with my other finger. And that creates a knot. Is that how everyone does it? It is, isn't it?
That's how I think so.
Yeah, well, that's what I thought, but Natasha was like, oh, I've never seen
that.
No,
that's exactly
but
how
that
I
is,
do it.
Yeah,
yes,
just twist it on your finger and do a thing. Yeah. She's like, what did you do there? So I thought I'd show it again for
anyone
who missed it the other day.
They're in my dressing room, Jay. Have you found them? Oh, good boy.
There we go.
Good boy. Oh, they're not mine. It's just probably anybody's glasses.
That's not
gonna work, I did that in a supermarket. I was buying this glass, you know, so I can have water on the set. And I said, well, I can't read this. She'll borrow my glasses. So I borrowed her glasses and I read it. And I said, well, thank you very much. Walked off with the one's glasses on. Anyway, they were very nice as well. Right, I'll let you do this. I'll let you concentrate.
All right, see. Well, I'm just gonna decide which one to do so you can see it better.
We're going
to
do all of them.
A good one. I am going to do all of them eventually, yes, but I'm not sure we'll get around to doing all of them today. So I'm going to start at the edge of the wing. This is going to be a bit fiddly, cameraman, so let's have a quick look. I'm going to start by poking my needle through from the back of this shape here, and I'm going to come through the fold, hopefully. There we go. So you can see I'm coming through the fold underneath,
yeah,
so that your knot should be halfway through on the back.
And hidden
under there. Yeah. And then I'm going to, basically, it's invisible stitch or ladder stitch. So I'm going to pop a stitch through the green. And then I'm going to do a stitch through the fold of the fabric. There we go. And then we're just going to move all the way around, doing the same.
So the cardboard's still in there, then?
Cardboard's still in there, yes. You should be not catching the cardboard with your stitches.
Yeah.
Because obviously we're going to be sewing on the edge. And we shouldn't have put, that was one thing I meant to say earlier, I try not to put the glue too close to the edge, because
right,
if you put it too close to the edge, obviously you've got a fiddly shape, but if you put it too close to the edge, sometimes your needle gets stuck a little bit in the glue once,
yes,
it's dried. So try and keep the glue away from right at the edges,
yes,
just so that when you're stitching through, because you need to stitch right at the edge, which is why I fold back, so you,
yes,
can see. So you can see that I'm stitching right on the fold, and then if you've got a fold to stitch through on the other side as well, it makes it easier. So, working my way around.
And
How big are stitches?
How big are your stitches?
Again, quite small, because we've got these wing shapes are very, very dainty.
Yeah.
So if I show you, I'm going to go in there. It's probably about two to three millimetres,
yeah,
going through there. That's a good shot. Well done.
Oh, yeah. Well done, Michael.
And again, the same on the other side. 2 to 3 mil, just along there.
Oh, now, just to warn you, we have got one of our management team watching upstairs, and he's fascinated. He's fascinated by this. Absolutely fascinated by it.
That means I'm allowed to stay, then. Moving round.
Somebody left a radio on. I can hear a radio.
Moving round the corner, yes, just refolding the piece underneath. I find it easier to stitch on the fold.
Yes.
Because obviously, that's what's going to be there in a minute. So, again, just popping down, ladder stitching through 2 or 3 millimetres, being really careful not to poke yourself in the finger. moving around. You can see if I pull that apart there again, you can see what that ladder stitch is looking like.
Hannah was saying she'd save this for a Sunday evening job, but it doesn't have to be on a Sunday evening, does it? No. Whatever, because it's a hobby. You just do it whenever you fancy.
I do.
I think it's because Hannah thinks that's the only night she's in. She stays in on a Sunday night.
I often do this if my husband's playing video games because he's a gamer.
Right.
And he, you know, we want to spend time together, but he wants to play games and we run out of movies to watch. So he plays video games and I sit and stitch.
Mm.
Particularly hand stitching. I'm quite
Can you
a
talk
fan.
To him while he's doing playing on his game or whatever
yeah,
it's called?
Yeah. He doesn't mind having a chat.
I don't know, you see. I don't understand video games. Don't understand them at all.
Neither do I particularly. That's why I do so much. But we still get to spend time together. And I can talk to him about things and it's nice. It's a nice way to spend time with each other but still, you know, indulging our own
hobbies.
Exactly.
Exactly. Yeah, because it'd be very boring if you were just sitting there sewing and he was doing nothing or vice versa.
Well, absolutely. Sort of I think gaming and sewing goes together quite happily. I know a lot of people who have both. You know, a lot of sewists whose husbands are gamers.
Yes. So is he like doing medieval people climbing walls and things like that?
Oh, yeah. Well, all sorts. Yeah, everything. He likes everything.
Just so you know, lots of people are asking about the fabric that Sam is using.
Oh, yeah.
It's this beautiful, beautiful charm pack we've got here. At £17.95. You get two of everything, and it's the newest range from Tilda, the Bumblebee range from Tilda. You get gorgeous. Well, it's lovely that we're doing... Well, it's all tied in, isn't it? We're doing the Bumblebee collection fabric with the Bumblebee applique. Really, really lovely floral one there. I love... This is my favourite. This is kind of the... This kind of Pagoda-esque fabric. But then I also love this, the William Morris...
I love that.
..esque print. That is just stunning, isn't
Again,
it?
Again, a really good... I'm sure she did it on purpose, because she would have done, but the shaping for, like... you know, matching up a bumblebee body.
Yes.
Do you know what I mean?
Yes.
It works out really well.
Yes, exactly. So you could do something like that or like that, just the placing of it and everything. Perfect, isn't it? And that's the lovely one, the same one in pink. So you get two pieces in the charm pack of each of the fabrics. It's the newest collection from Tilda. It's beautiful, isn't it? The colours are out of this world. It's got a kind of vintage feel to it, doesn't it? But then that, you see, that's kind of vintage-esque, but with very modern, contemporary colours in there. Beautiful fuchsia pinks in there. Love that. The green and pink opposite each other on the colour wheel to give you that lovely, so they just go so beautifully together. That's nice, isn't it? That's a lovely, fresh design, that one. Then we've got that William Morris one, again, in the blue and the green. Look at that. That's beautiful, isn't it? So you get... 20, is it? How many pieces of... Hang on, I'm just looking. Gorgeous, isn't it? Absolutely beautiful pieces there. I'll carry on showing them to you. Lovely, isn't it? Beautiful. Oh, now lots of you are asking what the book is next week. I'll show you that in a second. I'll just carry on going through these fabrics. Just a couple more.
I love the pink version of that.
Yes,
kind
the
of
pink version, that's gorgeous, isn't
really
it?
Really bright colours with those kind of dainty florals, I think it's really lovely.
Fabulous. Really, really lovely. Beautiful. They are machine washable though, so. Right, this is the book you've all been asking about. Sorry, I'm just ignoring you while you're just
hand-stitching
there.
No, that's fine, I'm
there.
Just
We're not
stitching
anything,
away. Don't worry about me.
Oh, I was way back. Have a look. This is the book I've got on offer you in this show. Tilda's Studio, it's called. It's really, really gorgeous book. Step into Tilda's Studio with a collection of designs, projects and pretty photography inspired by the author, that's Tone, very own workroom and other favourite things. There are over 50 delightful new sewing designs, including cushions, accessories, home decor, jewellery, and bags. There are cute characters such as giraffes. Oh, my friend Cherry Pie like that. She loves giraffes. Elephants and angels. And Tilda's favourite shades of pink and red combined with splashes of teal, green and purple for a gorgeous, fresh feel. Now, let me just flick through the book for you because it is. Has the most beautiful, beautiful photographs in it. Look. The charm packet has 40 pieces in it. That's it.
This is one of my favourite ever Tilda books.
The Tilda phenomenon is like, it's just taken the world by storm, hasn't it, really?
It
Everybody. Look at that, aren't they cute? They're slippers, they are. But you can keep going on. But look at the back. In the back of the book, you've got all of the patterns. All of the patterns there. That one's, what's that angel called there? Cupcake angel. Cupcake angel. Now, you could either photocopy them or you could use grease proof paper to trace them off, so you don't have to actually cut these ones out. Because obviously on each page, there are different colours from different designs and everything. You've just got to work out which ones you need for the design.
My book is twice as thick now because I've traced off nearly all the patterns from this book and I've put them back in the book, so it's really...
Oh, so you've used this book itself?
Yeah, I love it.
There you go. How much is it? £14.95. Again, a fabulous, fabulous gift. Gift. I always think self-gifting, best way to go, because it means you always get the present that you want, don't you?
Yeah, absolutely.
So buy it, wrap it up for yourself for your birthday or for your anniversary or something like that. It is Tilda Studio, £14.95. What's that, Hannah? Oh, right, OK. I've got more fabrics to show you. Apart from... I'll take the charm pack with me. Okay, you carry on.
I'm going to carry on.
We will come back to Sammy. She's just stitching round. So, are we not showing a little film in this hour? Oh, okay, sorry about that. No, I didn't get any warning. we've got a little film for you here. Because you're new, because we're new, you might not know enough about us. So, here's a little film, just something about the Sewing Quarter.
Sewing Quarter is at the very heart of sewing as we bring you all things sewing and quilting. The team behind us live and breathe sewing day to day. We strive to bring you exclusive offers, exciting live demonstrations, and most importantly, we will custom cut fabric to your specification in our very own cutting room. We will also be bringing you TV exclusives that you won't be able to find anywhere else. So come and join us today at the Sewing Quarter.
Welcome to the Sewing Quarter!
You are loving the charm pack. I'm not surprised because you get 40 pieces, two of each. Remember, charm pack, they're 5-inch square, aren't they? And really, really beautiful fabric. It's the Bumblebee range, which is Tilda's newest range of fabric, £17.95. You get 40 pieces of fabric there to do with as you will. You could do the applique, you could do quilting, you could do whatever you want with them, really. Really, really gorgeous. Details there, £17.95. Really, really. Really lovely charm pack. But you might have noticed I've got other pieces of fabric behind me here. Now, these are individual fat quarters. You see, so each of these, they're beautifully packaged, look. Each of these are a fat quarter. Isn't that lovely? And it comes in... see how it's beautifully wrapped? Because, you know, fat quarters can come in any quantity, really, from one to... I think the biggest one we had was 29. We have is 29 pieces. So this is Flower Nest Green. So it's one single fat quarter for £4.95. So if you're making a cushion and or anything and you want something to put your applique onto, then these are lovely, aren't they? So that one's the green one. It also comes in... I'll just see which colour Hannah's going to next. OK. This is the next one here. There's obviously the blue one, this one. Really, really gorgeous. Very, very fresh with that cream background, isn't it? Really, really lovely there. That is a fat quarter, a single fat quarter, 50 centimetres by 55 centimetres for £4.95. Now, remember, no matter how many pieces you buy from us today, whether you buy a pair of scissors, the applique kit, one of these, it's only £2.95. And if you do go to the web and check out your basket, it's all consolidated at the end of the night, at the end of the evening, at about midnight. So it's all consolidated, so you only pay one P&P. Look at the pink. The pink is vibrant. The pink is gorgeous. Also, if you do ring to put it in your... if you ring up to buy it on the, at the call centre, 0800 112 44 33, they consolidate your order at the end of the night, still only paying £2.95 per whole day. So you can pop in and out as many times as you like during the day. By midnight, you will only pay one P&P. That's the Flower Nest Pink Fat Quarter. from the Bumblebee range. It is stunning, isn't it? Maybe you've never bought a Tilda before. Maybe you'd just like to try them out. Get one of these. The quality, isn't it, Sammy? The quality of the cotton.
Amazing. Really
is
amazing.
It's just beautiful, isn't it? Now I think I've got the teal next. Is this the teal one next?
Oh, I like that one too.
This is Hannah, producer Hannah's favourite. £4.95 there. Remember, it's a fat quarter, which is... they're taking a metre of fabric, haven't they? Cut it in half and cut it in half again, and then you get the fat quarter there. And then last but not least, I think this is one of Sammy's favourite, the orange.
Mm-hmm.
I presume yeah, they've
called
it orange.
They're all my favourite. I can't choose.
Right, oh, OK. Somebody's saying they've not seen a fat quarter before. I'll open this one for you. So I'll just take this off. See how beautifully packaged it all is. I'll just put that on my shirt there. This is how big your piece is in there. So you get 50 centimetres by 55 centimetres there. So what they've done is they've taken a metre of fabric, they've cut it in half across the bottom and half down the middle. So you're getting a quarter of a full-size metre of the fabric. So it's 50 centimetres by 55 centimetres. £4.95. So if you've never bought a Tilda piece of fabric before, what an ideal way of testing it out. And then add it to your order, because you only pay your one post and packaging for the whole day. I'll just show you these. I brought the packs across with me just to explain what the packs are as well. We're doing the Bumblebee one today. This is the Bumblebee Applique pack. Now, I think you get 180 pieces in there. I think that's 180 pieces, Sam, you were saying earlier, of really good quality cardboard. You can use them over and over and over again. £5.95. There's two sizes of bumblebee in there with two different sizes of wings. What a lovely present. What a beautiful present. And how beautifully packaged is it as well? It's all important, that kind of visual, isn't it? How gorgeous it is. So that one is the bumblebee one. One that you haven't seen is the dragonfly one. That's really cute, isn't it? The dragonfly one will be the same price at £5.95. You get 200 pieces in there, but each dragonfly obviously has four wings and the lovely little body there. I just think they're a fantastic little gift, aren't they? They fit beautifully. Like Tone, who is the inspiration behind Tilda, will have thought of this so everything goes with the whole range. This is the dragonfly one we're showing you there. £5.95. Just give the call centre a ring, 0800 112 4433. Or, of course, you can go on the web. The best way to do it is during the show, go to the live page and put it in your basket that way, because if you go to look for it on the web, you might not find it, because they might have all put them into our show and everything. The charm pack is just beautiful. Have a look at this. This is the still of the charm pack here. This is the fabric that we've been using to do this this project with Sammy here. So how are you getting on with your hand stitching there, Sammy?
I'm done.
Oh, brilliant.
So all I did was I didn't do a knot to finish it off. I just carried on a little bit further round and kept stitching and then threaded it through the very edge of the thing. I'm just going to strip that away.
Using our lovely little rose gold snippy scissors there.
Any excuse to use the rose gold scissors, really. Lovely. So that is all completely stitched down now. Stitched down all the way around. You can see I'm going to pull it up. None of it's going to come off anywhere.
Okay.
Nice and dainty. So then the next step we're going to do, one of my wings has fallen off.
Oh, dear.
Because this is just tack. Because just this is how the glue, you know, is quite... it's good. It's strong enough. But obviously, look again, it hasn't marked the fabric
anywhere. It's a blue one as well. You'd think there'd be a blue stain or something
but
there,
no,
wouldn't you?
Nothing.
Okay, Linda's asked... Do you remove the card once the glue is dry or do you leave it for now? I think that's... Is that the next stage we're going to do?
We're going to... Because obviously at the moment, we can't get at the cardboard because we've stitched it in.
Yes.
So what we do next do is we move on to the applique scissors.
OK, now these are important because I've never seen these before.
Yeah. So these have a duck bill. You may have seen them on a couple of shows a couple of days ago. They've got this duck bill and they've got a wedge blade on the other side. You can see just there.
I wonder why it's called a duck bill, because it looks like one of those pelican more than a duck.
I was going to say it is, well, yeah, but like stork and herons, isn't it?
Yes,
it's like,
yeah,
you
exactly.
know, but yes, they are.
Okay, so these are the duck bill applique scissors, 7.5 inches. So these are made specifically for the art of applique.
For applique or reverse applique, yes. They're basically the idea of the duck bill, the big, you know, funny looking side of the scissors,
yes.
and this wedge blade is that you can get in really close to your stitching without cutting the fabric underneath, because what happens is that this bill lifts the two fabrics apart.
Okay.
So that you can get in really close.
Okay. I just must point out, this isn't sharp, is it, here?
This is not sharp, no, but this bit...
I just was a bit worried, though. Yes, yes.
No, sorry, I was just moving my finger, and I was like, no, this piece is sharp here. This wedge blade, you can see, much thicker...
Oh, yes.
...than the blade on the other side, which is...
So the one on the other side looks like a normal scissor blade.
Yes, yeah,
but
normal
the one with the duck bill on it is cut on a wedge, so it's actually thicker.
Yes, and then it lifts
the fabric. See how this is going to work.
So I start with a little snip in the centre. There. You can see I've just made a little snip with my scissors. And then I will put my duck bill in and lift that glue, because again, I popped a little bit of glue. So you see how quickly that peeled off. And then I get in there, down the centre. And back up the other way.
So you're just going to just within your stitch line?
Yeah, close to my stitch. It's not too close, because again, if we go close, a bit like with the glue to the edge of the thing, or the cutting, the snipping too close to the edge, you're going to get those fibres kind of wanting to pull out. So not too close, but close enough. And then what we do is get in with the duck bill.
Yes.
In there and snip around. And what's happening is that you can see that duck bill is lifting that fabric up out of the way so that it doesn't... You're not going to snip through two layers.
It'll be nothing worse after you've hand-stitched it all.
Yeah, I've done that so many times with, like, using ordinary embroidery scissors to have annoyingly either snip through a thread or, snip through your fabric. It's really frustrating. So I'm just going to go around...
So, Linda, are you taking note, my love? Because there's the cardboard underneath there.
Yeah, you can see the card. So, very gently nestling it up to my stitches. You can see how far I've gone, kind of about 3 or 4 mil away.
Yes.
About as much as we've wrapped over. You can see the edge of the wrapping under there.
Okay.
And I'm going to carry on round.
If you're leaving the cardboard in, you don't need to do this, do you?
You don't need to, no. This is just if you're... obviously, if it's going to be something that's going to be washed.
Yes.
You want to make sure that... I'm just going to get in there. You're holding your breath, Jill.
I am.
All I'm going to do... I've got... Oh, here we are. Pin. I'm just going to pull the fabric away where we glued it.
Oh, OK.
We're just getting there with a pin and just... There we
are.
Oh,
that's a good tip, yeah.
Do you see what I mean? Just kind of easing that glue away. Sometimes you can just, it just does it on its own. Sometimes it's, I put obviously a big chunk of glue on this one. So just get your pin in there, because again, your pin can't do much damage. So that just pulls all that glue away from the underlying side of fabric. And then I'm going to get in there again with my duck bill. These are really lovely because they're really snippy. Some of the ones I've had in the past have been not really sharp to the point, and I'm sure a lot of people will understand how frustrating that is, not to have your scissors really sharp all the way to the point, particularly when you're doing something, again, so dainty.
You want
to make sure that you can get right in there. I'm just going to turn that around. Snip in. And I can use these without worrying because we know that that duck bill is stopping anything.
Yes, of course.
From going
are we going? Oh, and it's all three. You are being treated.
We've got to take the cardboard out. Can't do it.
Oh yes.
Take the cardboard out. There we go. Just get a snip in there. Again, just pulling that glue away. I'm actually doing it with the edge of the. That's very bad. I shouldn't do that. With the pin, get in there. Release that glue from the plate from the paper, and again, get back in. That duck bill nicely, as I say, keeps lifting that fabric away, so I don't have to worry at all about snipping anything. I shouldn't.
I've gone very quiet.
Sorry. I have too, because I'm concentrating.
No, I'm fascinated. I'm absolutely fascinated.
Okay. There.
Okay.
So that's that all out of the way. All the snipping, those applique scissors, invaluable for these little tiny fiddly bits.
And
I'm going to go back in with my pin, my needle. I'm going to use a pin because it's a bit easier to hold. And again, I'm going to get in there around the edges and just pull that fabric away where we've glued. So
okay.
I'm putting the point of my pin in between the fabric and the paper. If you get it, you can then start to peel.
Of course.
There we go.
Keep doing that. We've had a message from Claire. Oh, hello, Claire, from very near here, actually. Oh, now, you know, you were talking earlier about how your husband does the gaming video thing.
Oh, yeah, video
Well,
games, yeah.
Claire's husband does DJing in the bedroom while she's sewing. I wonder what
That's
kind of
amazing.
Tunes he... what kind of tunes? What do they say?
Tunes.
Well, they don't call tunes. Them tunes anymore. What discs they're going to scratch. Isn't that what they say?
It's all electronic now. They don't use anything.
Oh, don't they do that anymore?
No. I mean, old school, yes, DJs. But
well, I thought Pete Tong did this. Or what's the man who used to be married to Zoe Ball? He still is married to Zoe Ball. this, I thought he got two records and went like that.
Yeah, but now they're not real records. They're just, it's a gadget that does it, I think.
No, they do that anymore then.
Well, they do, like I say, they do it, but it's not real records. It's just like a machine that plays
There's no
it.
Art and, in that, I don't know. Well. Oh, no, I don't. Well, in my day, it was just she went up and did a request and said, could I have chic, please?
Yeah. Oh,
right.
Lovely.
Now everyone's shaking their head, they don't know who chic is. That's a bit embarrassing, isn't it? So you're going round with your pin.
Yeah, all the way around. What have I knocked on the floor? That's just my rose gold scissors. I'll pick those up in a sec. Okay, so I've done those two. I'll do the other one in a second.
Okay.
I'm now going to remove my card. So I'm just going to peel where I've got quite a bit of bulk here at the edge. And I'm just going to start peeling carefully because I want to retain the cardboard inside. But you can see when I take it out how... Oh, I'll stitch through it. That's not helpful. That's all right. You can still do it.
Yeah.
You can still take it out. You just need to be more careful. There we go.
So where's the glue disappeared to then?
Well, it's basically just disappeared. I mean, it's still there. You can still see a little bit of glue in the centre there. But it's no longer sticky. And actually, if you rub at it and scrape most of it away, it disappears.
Like magic glue.
Yeah.
But it hasn't marked the fabric at all.
Absolutely nothing on the fabric. That's the thing I love about them is that you don't have any horrible residue. And even if you do, when you wash it, it will completely disappear.
Okay, perfect. So if it's on a blouse or something, like a napkin or something, you can get it. Okay, the shapes that Sammy's pulling out, they're part of the applique kit here. This is the Bumblebee applique kit. They're £5.95. Oh, now, well, here you go. So we've got the Bumblebee one here for £5.95. It also comes in the Dragonfly. You can just ring the call centre, 0800 112 4433, or go on the web and you'll see both of them. That is the Dragonfly one there, also £5.95. Fantastic. Lovely, lovely, lovely gift there. What else have you seen in this show? The Charm Pack. The Charm Pack is just beautiful. Now this, well, let me take that one out from underneath. This is the Charm Pack, right? And you get 40 pieces of 5-inch squares. It's the newest range. It's the Bumblebee range from Tilda. You get two of each of the fabric designs there. Ideal for a project like this, ideal for patchworking. Just gorgeous to have. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful fabrics. That's £17.95. So you get two, as you see, of each of those. Beautiful. It's such good quality cotton. At £17.95. Gorgeous, aren't they? Absolutely stunning. We also had the Fat Quarters, remember, in the same fabrics. In the Daisy fabric over there. They were all there. That's the Charm Pack there. They're gorgeous, aren't they? That's it, the Bumblebee £17.95 Charm Pack. Really, really beautiful. What else did we show? Oh, we showed you the glue sticks. Oh, we had some messages about the glue sticks. This is the refill. This is the refill here, the blue refill, which is the blue one that Sammy's been using today. A lot of you are loving these now. A lot of you did buy the pen the other day. And so this is the refill here, the two refills at £2.45. Really nice. And then, of course, there's the pen there that we've got available today as well, fabric glue pen. That'll come across the bottom of the screen there. Oops, there it is. Gone and come and gone. Soluble glue stick and blue refill at £5.95. Right. What else? Oh, we asked people what else you could use it for. Oh, English paper piecing, Jane said she used this for.
Yeah, this is...
And say that again. Oh, holding zips in place for lightweight fabrics.
Yeah. Again, tacking, great.
Oh, for handle, working with handles on bags. That's fantastic. Right, thank you, Sammy. You're back in an hour's time, aren't you, with...
Just going to do a reveal.
Oh, sorry, yes, reveal on the other side, of course.
So that's what it looks like on the other side. And the joy of it then, without your papering, is that it's nice and soft.
Fantastic, isn't it? Sammy's back in an hour's time with, a gorgeous Pandalicious cushion. But next, don't go anywhere, because Jo Carter's up next. She's making the most beautiful little owl. Oh, it's not little, it's quite big.
It's
so
adorable.
Don't go anywhere, make yourself a cup of tea, and join us in 3 minutes' time with Jo Carter. We'll see you in an hour. Don't go anywhere. Really, really, really little beautiful owl. See you in three.
Join us on Friday the 17th, where we'll be showcasing ideas for the very hungry caterpillar with guest designer Jo Carter. 8 a.m, how to make a baby changing bag. 10 a.m, create your very own baby cot quilt. Make sure you don't miss out.
My name's Sammy Claridge, and I run an online fabric supplies store, and I freelance do projects for magazines like Simply Sewing and Molly Makes. I've been sewing all my life. My mum taught me. She was a seamstress in the West End in the 60s, and she was always very practical. My dad was practical too. He got me making things in the garage with him, and my granddad taught me to paint, so I've got a very creative background, luckily. I think my favourite thing to make is probably accessories, so handbags and zip top bags, anything small and neat. I like things that I can get finished quite quickly. I'm quite an impatient sewer. So I would say, yeah, small crafty projects, quick things to make. My top sewing tip to any viewers would be to take your time, you know, in daylight hours if you can, to, you know, setting aside some time to do the project. Why do I want to work with immediate media? About 6 years ago, I saw the initial layout pages for Molly Makes. Before it was even together as a magazine, it was just literally storyboard images of the hands holding the reels of thread and things like that. And I knew that that was a publication that I wanted to work with. And as soon as Immediate Media bought Molly Makes magazine, I knew that they were a company that I wanted to work with. They have a way of producing things that is to a certain quality level that no other magazine seems to be able to do. I've been in the industry for a long time, so to see it come to a level where it's now going to be accessible to so many more people, and to be able to practically see people doing skills and teaching techniques on TV, where you can fast forward and rewind and watch over and over again, and it's going to be invaluable to the community. Plus, it gets those gorgeous fabrics and trimmings and tools that you may not know what to do with at all. You know, we can teach you that, and we can show you the best way to use it, and then, you know, you can pass those skills on to your friends. I think I'm really looking forward to learning new skills. I am primarily a dressmaker and a craft sewist, so I'm really looking forward to watching the quilting segments and learning new techniques within the quilting segments, because that's something I've done in the past, but it's not something that I have excelled in the past. And I'm looking forward to learning new skills from my fellow designers, really.
Welcome back. Now, welcome back to Owl Hour. I know I've been trying to practicing saying it all break. Do you know what I love? Everything I love about Jo Carter's soft toys is they've all got their own little personality. They've all got their own little character, haven't they? We did a pussycat the other day that just was so naughty. We had a lovely Dachshund sausage dog, which, look at this owl, right? I mean, he's beautiful, but look at his little tail. Little tail feathers. Can you see that? There you go. Little tail feathers on the back. Look, He's just gorgeous. Now, Joe's going to show us how to make those in a minute, but before we go over and meet Joe, I've got to take you through the fabrics, because they're really, really gorgeous, gorgeous fabrics in this owl. Now, we've made a little owl out of them. Just standing here in the break, I thought of so many different things I'd use these fabrics for. And you will have your ideas as well, which please, please, please let us know if what you have ideas as soon as you see them. Okay, so here we go. First one, this one first. There we go, which is gorgeous, isn't it? Now, you know it's Makua, it's a Makua fabric. You know that it is fantastic, fantastic, fantastic quality cotton, this. This is called the Scatter Antique Garden Fabric. Now, if you're new to us, I just need to point something out. We sell our cut fabric at half metre increments. So that the minimum you can buy is half a metre. And then after that, you buy of increments of half a metre. So you can buy half a metre, 1.5 metres, 2 metres. If you're buying on the web, half a metre is 1 unit. So a metre would be 2 units. If you have any doubts, just give us a call, 0800 112 44 33. And the call centre will be able to tell you everything you need to know. And when you buy cut fabric, it comes in the most beautiful box wrapped in tissue paper for the cut fabric. So I love this. I'll go through it a bit more with you again later. I love the motifs all over this one. Should we just have another look at all those lovely motifs? Look at them. I've got some hyacinths coming through in my garden. All my daffodils are out as well. No daffodils in there, but isn't that lovely? My old neighbour, my neighbour, when I used to live in Twickenham, Chrissy, she's not old, she would have loved that. She loved everything with gardening. No, the neighbours have got now old, but they won't mind me saying that. They're gorgeous. They look after me so well. Right, then moving on to, so that was the Scatter. Then there's this one, which has got a lovely kind of vintage feel to it, hasn't it? Really, really lovely vintage. It's called Scenic. Scenic Antique Garden Fabric by Makua. Again, £5.45 by the half metre. I will get them all out and I'll waft them for you later, but they're beautiful. Just having a little taster now. That is gorgeous. I love the colours and I love all the kind of vintage detailing of it. This next one I know is going to be so popular, I can't tell you. It's the bicycles. It's the beautiful, beautiful bicycle fabric here. And it's just adorable. It's really, really lovely. Look, it's fun, isn't it? It's fun, like a delivery bike. But then you've got your window boxes and your flower pots on them. Now, do you know what? Is it in Vietnam where you see all the ladies cycling with flowers all over their bikes? It's just beautiful, isn't it? I love, love, love that print. It's like an antique bike with flowers on it. It's called the Blue Bicycles Antique Garden Fabric. £5.45 for 50 centimetres. I will get all these out for you again later. Very quickly, just moving on. Now, Jo's used this one on her lovely owl here. I don't know if the owl's got a name. We'll have to ask you in a minute. It's like a linen effect. It's like a linen effect fabric. It's called the coral pink. Now, it's a very, very subtle coral. I'd say it was more pale terracotta myself rather than a coral. £4.95. £4, I took for half a metre, for 50 centimetres. It's a really, I don't know if you tell he's doing it as much justice. It's a really, really gorgeous colour, that one. Very subtle. Don't need to buy it with any of these fabrics. It's going to be good for your stash. It's a really lovely colour for your stash. £4.95 for the half a metre. Then I've got the last two at the bottom here. These are cute, aren't they? They're the same range. Really, really same range. Gorgeous. Blue daisy, that's the blue daisy there. And then this is the, that's the blue daisy that you say. And this is green daisy. It's green daisy. Now, the green is it's not a forest green. It's a really lovely, I know what it looks like. Kiwi, like kiwi green, that one there. That's one down there. And really lovely. That's £5.45 for, they all look so lovely together. Right, let's go and see Joe. You've had enough of me. Let's go and see Joe. Hello, my lovely. Give me a hug.
Good morning.
How are you?
This I'm very well.
Is so cute, but you've got lots of sewing to do, haven't you? You're going to make this from scratch for us, aren't you?
Hopefully. I've managed to get one done in the time.
No, not hopefully.
Definitely.
Definitely.
Positive thinking.
It looks so complicated.
It's not. It's really simple, and it's made from simple shapes. So there's no. I've designed it so there's not a pattern as such. There are just squares and rectangles. And
right.
Circles.
If people need to know the sizes of a rectangle, first of all, you can get it on YouTube, After the show, all the shows go on YouTube, so you can watch and pause and everything like that. Or you can watch it on the web. It goes on a loop on the web after midday. But if they need to, if they miss any of the measurements, then they can ring the call centre, can't they, and get the measurements from
yes.
the call centre. Perfect. Right, I'll let you get on.
Right.
Has he got a name?
No, and I was definitely
message
trying
in.
To think of one then.
Message in with... just have a quick look at him. I promise I'll shut up in a minute. Have a look at this, right? Hannah's saying he's a hoot. Is it a boy or a girl, though? It's definitely a boy. It's definitely a boy, apparently. Right, I will let you get on, because I know you've got lots to do. But let us know the name that you think it should be called.
A small child once told me that if it has eyelashes, it's a girl. But if it doesn't, it's a boy. So it must be a boy.
Oh, must be a boy. So, do you put owl eyelashes on your owls?
No, I must always make male owls.
Okay. There you go. So screams volumes, that, doesn't it? Right, OK, so...
Right, I'm going to start with the headpiece, which also is the tailpiece.
OK.
So we
doesn't
want...
make any sense, but... The fabric.
It will all become clear in a minute. So start off with two squares cut on the bias so that the print will be the correct way round because it forms that shape
the
on
face.
The front.
Yeah.
So I've used different fabrics, one for the top, one for the bottom. So start off placing them right sides together and then sewing all the way around the edge, not leaving a space for turning.
But it's going to be inside out.
It will work. I will cut it in a minute.
So. Can I just say, I know you cut this, it's no good for your home. You smell delicious today.
Oh, thank you.
Whatever your perfume you're wearing is absolutely lovely. We need smell-o-vision, smelly-telly. You smell delicious. Absolutely delicious. Anyway, so what I don't understand is if you're going to sew around all four edges...
I'm going to slice it. So,
yes.
So a section will be the tail and a section will be the head.
Is it called slicing? Is that what the technique is known
no,
as?
No, it won't be called that, will it?
Remember the fabrics Joe's using. The pattern one is the... you can't see it because it's wrong side showing at the moment. £5.45 for 50 centimetres. And the other one, the coral pink, which is more of a terracotta, but it is a lovely, lovely fabric. It's a linen texture fabric, £4.95 for half a metre. Any questions, just message us or just ring the call centre. Any names for the owl? Any names for the owl? I will test everybody here. Ginger Mike will have to think. Actually, it doesn't look unlike Ginger Mike, to be quite honest. He looks a little bit like that himself. Any names you've got for your owl, for the owl, let us know. So we're just sewing around all four edges.
Speed up.
Will I need to get the iron out at all for this?
We will need the iron.
I'll do it. Shall I do it now so it's here? So what else do you think you could use this fabric for? Producer Hannah's got an idea. Oh, yes, annealers. Annealer for when you're doing your gardening. You know, kneeling down to your weeding. The fabric would look nice.
That'd be great. Yeah.
Right, OK. So we've sewn around all four edges.
Yes. And we want to make a cut now. Now, a long ruler like this is perfect because we want to cut the centre line here 1¾ inches above it. It works out, I'll just check my notes. If you want to measure, if you don't have a ruler like this and you want to measure down, I think it's about 4½ inches.
This is our sewing quarter ruler. By all means, look on the web for that. Or we'll put the graphics up for you now. So just tell us how that works then, how you know to cut 1½ inches from that centre line.
So I'm using this ruler, 1¾, so it's this line here. And if I just line up this line with either corner on either side, I'll have
one and three quarter inches. So it's 1½ plus the seam allowance, is that what it is?
It is, yes.
Okay.
So I'll just take that off.
That's the 45mm rotary cutters, which you're all very, very familiar with.
And then I'm going to turn these the right way out.
Okay, now can we just check this again? So you've literally sliced that.
Yes.
So that line there is 1¾ inches from that line there.
From the centre, the diagonal centre, yes.
Yes. Okay.
And it's important to make sure the print is going the right way.
Of course, which is why you cut it on the bias.
Yes. And so...
So if you didn't have a directional fabric, you could just cut it
straight?
It wouldn't
if you had a solid fabric, it wouldn't make any difference.
Okay. So it's not, you're not using it on the bias for the stretch or anything like
that? No, just for the print.
Okay.
And now I'm going to clip off the corners just to allow it to turn.
They're lovely, these rose gold scissors, aren't they? They're very posh.
Somebody might be getting these for Mother's Day.
Might you?
My mum.
Oh, she's not watching. Oh, you've ruined it.
Well,
now.
No, I might have ruined the surprise now.
Yes. We can get to something else as well. Fabulous Mother's Day present, though, isn't it? Right.
Right, so I'm going to turn this the right way out. The tail as well. And then I'll give these a little press.
Oh, that's the tail!
It is.
Oh, I see.
In a minute, we'll fold the sides in to form the tail.
I wouldn't have thought. You see, you're known as the queen of using every bit of fabric, aren't you? I would have pushed that to one side, then started making a tail with another piece of fabric. So using, you're just pushing the corners out. So this finished shape is your head.
It is. So it sort of forms the ears and the beak.
I'll just move out of the way. How fascinating. All right, carry on.
Okay, so I'll give these a press.
Oh, something sticky on the floor there. Somebody's been using glue while I've been away. So now the quality of this fabric makes it easier, doesn't it? Because it's such a beautiful cotton, isn't it?
It's really nice. It's got a nice, smooth, sort of buttery sort of feel to it. It's super soft.
This is the scenic antique garden fabric that you're seeing there. This is a close-up of what it looks like on the folder. We'll go and waft all these fabrics for you in a little while. That is really cute, isn't it? We've just had a dragonfly. In the last time, there's one down in the corner above the owl hour. I can't see the bee. Oh, he's up there by the wheelbarrow. There's another one. Oh, there's another one up there by the... Oh, there's loads of them now. Really gorgeous details. Like a hand-printed fabric. Like a hand-drawn fabric, isn't it, that one? So
I'll just prep the tail so these are done.
Right.
And then I'll fold it in half just to find the centre. And then just fold each side, just so it slightly overlaps the centre.
That's reminding me of a pastry, some sort of pastry. I don't know why. I'll just show you this again. So you've got half. You took the halfway mark and you folded that one to just over the half, and then that one to just over the half. Oops, over the half as well. So you get that. Why is it reminding me of a pastry?
I sort of think it looks a bit like a napkin as well.
Oh, a napkin, yes. Well, there you go. You're doing I'm doing the eating. You're doing the tidying up afterwards. So that's the little tail that we come to again later, is it?
No, I always baste things. Okay. Once I've put a fold in something, I like to make sure it stays there. So I'll just, inside the seam allowance.
On the machine, you baste it?
On the machine, just to hold it in place. And then if it's within the seam allowance, the stitches don't need to be removed later. They're just
holding it.
Just gluing it together, really.
And it's just a normal stitch, just normal size stitch.
Yes, I mean, you can make it wider. If you think it might, the fold's not quite right or it won't work first time, you can always do a bigger stitch so it's easier to...
Okay. And you've not cut the dog legs.
Dog ears,
aren't
they? It went completely out of my head.
No dogs were harmed in the making of this owl.
So there we go, there's the tail.
Yes, I've got dogs on my shirt.
I love that shirt.
Thank you. I'll cut the ears off now, or the legs. Right, so that's the tail. We've got the tail made there. We'll just put the tail up there by him then.
Right, and I'll do the wings. The wings are just 3-inch squares and folded on the diagonal. So I'll fold
it out. Now you've cut those on the straight, though, have you?
They're on the straight, so that the... And you will have to check when you're folding them if we want this one for this side, because otherwise the print might be upside down. So I want them folded that way so that the print's the correct way up on each wing.
Oh, OK, let me just see then. So that's one wing there. And that's the other. So you're just making sure your fold is there so that you've the directional... So you do have to check the direction of your fabric, yes?
You do.
So don't make two right wings, then, or two left wings.
Although, I mean, I'm not sure anybody would really notice, especially with a print like this,
you
where
would.
There's so much going on. I probably
yes.
would.
Now, is this owl wise, do we think, or is it confused? So what are you doing, sorry?
So I folded this over, so this will be the wing, and I just want to sew across the bottom of the wing, so along here.
Okay,
so it's got a folded side and seamed across the bottom.
OK.
So I'll just do that quickly.
Look at him. He does look a bit befuddled, doesn't he? Befuddled the owl, that one looks. No, because owls are clever, aren't they? So just have a clever name. Not Hannah, definitely not Hannah. Producer Hannah, definitely. Well, it's a boy, Hannah. It's not a girl. It's not got eyelashes like you. Right.
And I folded the wing, stitched along one side, and I'm just going to trim because it's quite a small point.
Yeah.
I'm going to trim the seam allowance down a little bit just to maybe take a little bit more. Like
okay.
that.
And what shall we be using this bit for?
I'm sure I can think of something.
I'll put it in the file ready for later. That's what I understand.
Is there a point turner or...
Oh, yeah, Derek the Dobber.
Is he around?
Here he is.
Thank you.
I haven't seen Derek for ages, actually. Has he been in this week? No, he's not been in this week, has he?
Okay.
Oh, Hannah's not been in all week, so I don't know why she answered.
I'll give the wing a little press.
Oh, you're going back to the pressing,
yes,
sorry.
And I have made...
Oh, you've already made the other
just in case we're a bit short of time.
I don't think so.
Do you think we're going to do okay? There we go, so I've got two wings.
Now, a lot of people text in saying, oh, how will I watch YouTube? What you do is just go to the YouTube page and search Sewing Quarter, and all the shows we've done since, I don't know how long ago it is now, every show since the beginning is now on YouTube. And the joy of doing that is if you watch it on the web later on, you can't pause it. Well, you can pause it. When you come back, it's jumped to where it's meant to be. It hasn't paused. Whereas on YouTube, you can pause it, do the wings. Pause it, do the tail. Pause it. So it's fantastic. Okay.
Okay, so now we're going to put the bits on the front of the body. Now, the body front is 8 inches wide by 13
inches long.
Inches long. Just check my notes to make sure I'm going to
get the information. So we're just doing this bit here?
This is the front one.
Oh, just the front body?
Yes.
Just the front body there.
Now, before we do attach anything to it, I need to make some markings.
Okay.
On the front.
What are you marking, then?
I'm marking so I know it actually folds here at the top, and just so I know where the seam for the back piece will meet the front. I need to measure down 3¼ inches. I'm just worried about making the wrong measurements. Yes, it's 3¼, so I'll use my ruler to do that.
Using the wipe-off marker there, excuse me, at £2.45, that will wipe off with a damp cloth, won't it?
I use these all the time. They're great for toys.
So much has changed since I trained, you know. It's only tailor's chalk when I trained. And what did we have earlier in... the glue. We never had a glue pen when I was learning how to do it. We had a glue gun. We had a glue gun, and I'm only 39, yes. I wish.
And then from the bottom, we want to measure 5½ inches up, and this will tell us where the bottom of the wing should be. So I'll make those marks on there.
Using the sewing quarter ruler there.
There we go. Oh, what have I done with the lid? Oh.
I'm being tidy on the top, sorry. Okay, so...
So this is the top with the shorter measurement. So I'm just going to fold it in half just to find the centre.
Oh, now the back of that fabric has got like a linen effect on the... You haven't put anything on there, have you?
No.
Well, that's nice.
It's lovely, because linen can be really difficult to work with.
Yes.
And I love linen effect.
But this is linen really effect. Nice. It's brilliant, because linen increases the minute you touch it.
It does, and it frays as well, and this doesn't. It's great.
OK, so let's concentrate now.
I'm going to fold the headpiece over to find the centre as well. Give that a finger press.
OK.
And then I want to position that so I've got the creases lined up. In the middle there. And I'll just pop a pin in the centre, and then I'm going to baste this in place.
Okay.
So I'll do that quickly.
Is this a new design, or have you made this one before?
This is a new one, especially for this show.
Oh, fantastic. For our Owl Hour, brand new one. There we go, that's the... Now, the fabric that we're using to do the body, it's the Makoa linen texture fabric. Now, it's called a coral pink. I'd say it was more of a terracotta, wouldn't you?
Yes.
A light terracotta.
Definitely.
£4.95 for 50 centimetres. How much fabric do you need to make this owl, would you say?
Not too much. I think you could probably... Out of half a metre, you could get, I would think, probably 4 or 5 out of it.
Oh! So you can make a whole family!
A parliament! I looked up the collective now.
A group of owls is called a parliament.
It is a parliament. You could make your own parliament of owls. They'd look nice along the bottom of a bed.
Oh, that's, so if you bought half a metre of that fabric and half a metre of that fabric, you can make a whole family, whole
you
parliament.
Could.
Yes. Okay. So you've just stitched that there. Can you explain where that is on there, then? Which bit have you just stitched? I'm a bit lost.
Here. So I've basted
the back of the head.
Yes, so it will fold over like that, and then this will be...
Ah, brilliant. Okay.
The front.
Carrying on.
And I'll make the eyes, because it's easier to fix the eyes on at this stage.
Oh, is it?
It is. So the eyes...
The eyes, they add the character to it, don't they?
They do.
Really, just by... I mean, they're simple. I'll just turn it to the camera. There you go. Oh, he's cute. Lots of people collect owls, exactly. What's your trick behind the eyes, then? You've just taken a disc of the fabric.
Yes, so it's a 2.5 diameter, that's the word, circle. Now, so that the fabric behind, the print, doesn't show through, you could put these straight on. If you wanted to remove the seam allowance, so they were 2 inches diameter,
right.
You could put them straight on. You could do them in felt if you want, but I like the coordinating eyes.
Oh, yes.
And this is...
You're going to bag them out?
Yes, but I'm going to sew all the way round. I know people don't like curves and circles in sewing, but it's fine to just do a couple of stitches and adjust. And
there's only two.
They're not very big. It's...
So you're going to leave a gap to pull it through and everything, like a normal bagging out?
No, I'm going to sew them all together, and then I'm going to cut a little hole in the back of one.
Oh. And this is clever, isn't it? So you wouldn't... Oh, no, I'll be quiet.
Go on.
No, I was going to say, you wouldn't put the eye detailing on now, but you're going to stitch the eye detailing through both layers, aren't you? Not,
yes.
Because normally when you decorate one... Like, if you do a cushion, you'd do all the decoration on one side before you put the back on, wouldn't you? Whereas you're going to stitch through both layers of this to... do you know what would be nice? If you put a little bit of wadding in, then you could quilt the eyes, and they'd be kind of... Owl eyes like that, really kind of...
They'd be great. And yes. Even a little bit of a disc of felt in would give them that extra bit of shape as well.
Hannah's saying, could you possibly make some glasses for it? Because she'd like
those
glasses. Oh, it
would look great with glasses.
Wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Would you just embroider that? Would you just embroider and stitch some glasses on?
Embroider or applique.
Oh.
Oh, I wish I...
Hannah's got so overwhelmed with it all now. So it's... You can't take toys to school on your first day, Hannah. Hannah's saying, take it to school on your first day. And, when they come home from school on their first day. It's their present when they come home. Have all your kids started school now, then?
They have.
Oh, so it's not a very good idea for you, then.
Well, the show and tell on a Thursday, they could always take it.
Oh, school's changed.
It has. So I've sewn all the way around.
Right.
And then I want to clip V-shaped notches at regular intervals all the way around. Just it helps with turning and removing some of the bulk from the seam at the side.
Yeah.
So it lies a bit flatter.
Now, I've noticed that both you and Sammy use the big scissors to do your... cutting out bits like that, your notches.
Well, they're really sharp all the way.
Hold your fingers.
Yes, I need to be a bit careful.
These are the rose gold, hemline rose gold premium dressmaking shears, £16.95. Very sharp.
They are.
And very gorgeous, the rose gold.
Beautiful.
We sell the little snippy ones in rose gold as well.
I do.
Yes. Have they been taken away? Oh, Sammy's obviously taken them. She loves that rose gold. She's like a magpie, that woman. Oh, have you ever made a magpie?
I've never made a magpie, actually. It's one of the few things.
Oh, well, let's make a magpie. Not now. I don't mean now. We're doing an owl now, but...
And so when it's been stitched and clipped...
Yes.
..then you want to cut a little hole...
And how are you going to do that?
..in one side. So just pull it apart. Just make a slit.
And you're going to bag it through that little hole?
I am.
Why have you done that rather than leave... Oh, because you don't want to hand-stitch a curve. Is that why you're doing it, like, that way around? You know, like, most people... Not most people.
You're making me sound odd.
No, we know we're all odd here, aren't we? When you do normal bagging out, you leave a little bit... You don't stitch all the way around, do you? And then you bag out through the little bit that you've not bagged out. Then you turn it in, hand-stitch it down. I just wondered why you were doing it with a hole in the back rather than a...
It's just a bit tricky to... Close a curve, it just makes it a little bit easier. So if you just roll the seams, just pull them apart a bit so that the seam allowance just settles nicely behind.
Do you know, normally you come on the telly and you always get a sniffy nose?
I know, I have.
I've got it today.
Sorry.
It's that lovely perfume that you wear, it's obviously that's what it is.
And then if you give them a press.
And they told me to be quiet. Of course, you make two of these, wouldn't you?
And I have one I've made earlier as well.
Oh, have you?
I've tried to do a bit of
this. Did you not go to bed last night? There's an awful lot of things you've already made.
And then, let's see where my spare eye is.
Two I've already made.
And you just want to position these, try and get the grain going. It just makes it look a little bit neater.
Okay.
Just position them so that the beak is formed in the centre.
Oh, well, just have a look at that on the overhead camera. It's coming in. There it comes. Okay.
And then pop a pin in.
Oh, so you can... Oh,
I'm
okay.
going to stitch them now because it holds this piece down.
Yes. So, as well as doing the decorating, you're actually... The decorating holds pieces in place.
Yes, it has a function as well. So now I'm going to do a running stitch around the outside and then I'll use the pen to draw a pupil. And then... Embroider the
pupil. Oh, okay, pupil. I was
going to say. I've threaded a needle, I'll just go and grab that.
You've done it already?
I'm trying, yes. Because. Oh,
oh, you're all right there.
Because I was worried about not quite having enough time. I want to make sure I get to everything, so I've pre threaded my needle.
No, that's excellent. So now you're just doing a normal straight stitch, a stab stitch. What would you call it?
Just a running stitch,
running
a straight stitch all the way around.
It's like a stab stitch as well, isn't it?
It is.
Thank you.
Because it holds them together.
They're laughing at me upstairs for getting the wrong word, but it is called a stab stitch as well.
Right, I'm going to do this swiftly.
I need more faith in myself, don't I? Got a little pep talk from Tomo this morning, one of our managers. Have more faith in yourself, John. I can still hear that radio. Maybe it's next door.
It's not my stomach this time.
No, it's not your tummy today. I'll tell you the other day, there was you, me and Angie all with rumbly tummies. So now, when I learned to sew, I always wore a thimble. I noticed none of our designers, I wear thimbles.
I find it gets in the way, but that's why my nails are always, because I use my nail a bit as a thimble, which is why they're never in particularly great shape.
Have you done them especially for the show then? Because they always look really... I was about to say earlier, though, but then Hannah was saying, I'm paying too many compliments, I'm getting a bit creepy. It's because you smell nice, you look nice, you've got nice nails.
I still feel relaxed, don't worry.
You what?
I still feel relaxed.
Oh, good. Well, I should hope so. I'd hate to make you feel uncomfortable. Yes, lots of you loving the fabric. I will be going through it all in a minute. We'll just do one eye... And then we'll go and look at the fabrics. Brian. Julie says Brian the owl.
Brian the owl.
Does it mean Brian or brain?
Oh, Brian. Because it is an anagram of...
Yes. Well, it could be
clever.
Hannah's reading as well.
Right, I'm going to have to get a tissue.
Do you want a tissue?
Is there...
You're right.
Sorry.
It's all right.
Whenever I'm
on... When you concentrate,
it is. It must be.
Maybe you're allergic. Maybe you're allergic to me, really. Maybe that's what it is. Did you do it with Natasha as well? Has it happened with Natasha as well?
No, it didn't happen.
Oh, no! No, don't say that. They'll part us.
Right, try and speed up a little.
Oh, the fabric that's on his head here is the antique garden fabric there, half a metre for £5 and 45 pence. Tell us what you plan to make with it. Oh, that's, who was that then? Oh, it didn't sound like Tim. It sounded like it was in a different room. It sounded like it came from Becky in the room behind. Oh, okay. No, I didn't say you sounded like Becky. It sounded like from where Becky was coming from. Christine, hello, Christine, my love. What a hoot. What a hoot this show is. Hannah said that earlier, Christine. I wouldn't say it because it came from Hannah. Because it's from you, my lovely. I'll talk about it. Say that again. Oh, decorating a back front. That'd be nice, yeah. I'd make... if you watch Escape to the Country... And do you watch Escape to the Country?
I do.
Oh, I love that programme. When they go into a country kitchen and some of them have got curtains going around their... not their pelmets, but, you know, around where all their saucepans are and things like that. This fabric, this printed fabric looked gorgeous, wouldn't it?
It would. There's so much going...
Oh, Jenny's definitely going to have a go at making the owl. Which Jenny's that? Jenny from West York. Jenny... I went to university, got my first degree. I went to Bretton Hall in West Yorkshire. I love it. It's the most fabulous county, isn't it, West Yorkshire? But thank you. Oh, she's finding the show very relaxing. Is that because I'm not shouting? Is that before what, Timothy? Was West Yorkshire better than Hollywood, he said. West Yorkshire's beautiful. Oh, Julie, thank you. She's loving the channel. It's a breath of fresh air. Thank you.
Okay, I'm gonna...
Oh, okay, she's named them Owl Hooter. And what's she saying about the eyes? Anyway. What are we doing here?
I'm going to draw the pupil on. I'll do the other one in a minute, but I'll just show the pupil.
Yeah, because when you do the other one, I'll go over and show the fabric. So we'll just see you finish that eye off. Okay. This one's going to... I can see already this one's going to look different to this one. It's got a different character already just from that one eye, I can tell.
It's all in the eyes, I think.
Yes, it is. Where are you going?
Pre-threaded needle.
So, yeah,
I've tried to be prepared.
It shows how to do the... There's the centre of the eye now. Round the outside of the circle.
Yes.
I've got you. Hannah said she was watching or reading embroidery techniques this weekend. Oh, not this. I keep thinking it's Monday because I've been off for a couple of days. And we went on one of our magazines, one of our Simply Sewing or Quilting magazines. And she said this is one of the embroidery techniques. So you're backstitching round. Is there any reason you're backstitching it?
Just to give me a guide to work from. And it's just a little bit easier to get a solid line of stitches. Backstitch tends to be the easiest way. Doing it.
You wouldn't do any of this on a machine. Well, you couldn't really do the embroidery. Could you? No, you'd always do this by hand.
You could do. You could certainly sew around the edge there on a machine, especially doing it whilst it's flat as well.
Yes, yeah. But I think it's quite nice with the hand stitching because it's going to, like we were saying, going to give the owl its character, isn't it?
It is.
So we're just back stitching all the way. So you could make that centre bit as wide, as big, or as little as you want, couldn't you?
Really teeny ones, or you could do it in a different colour. I always think it'd be nice to do sort of wavy, like embroider, backstitch, sort of wavy lines to mimic feathers on his stomach. Or
Hannah's desperate for you to embroider some glasses on.
There we go.
Karen says, hello, everybody, good morning. Oh, she loves the antique garden fabric. She already ordered some. You're right there.
I've put hand cream on my hands before coming on, and now I can't grip the needle.
Would you like me to pull it
through? Would you mind? Thank you.
She's going to make a cotton and knickknacks holder out of her fabric.
Perfect.
To sit on her desk. Oh, that sounds nice. Julie. We'd call the owl Bertie.
Bertie's a cute name. Oh. I've just about managed it that time.
Oh, yeah. Now, Julie said she'd call the owl Bertie, and she said she's going to make one, but bigger, and make a cushion out of it.
It'd be perfect for a cushion, really nice and... Because it's got some depth to it, but it still is sort of squarish.
Yes.
I'm going to have to ask you. So, from then...
To make it individual... Bead embroidery. Do you mean put beads on? Put beads on to make the eyes.
What was I thinking of putting hand cream on?
That one is... There you go.
So from then, just do straight stitches along just to fill in the pupil.
So you've gone around the outside. Now you can do one big stitch.
Just big stitches.
Big stitches.
Big stitches, yeah, the technical term. There we go, just to fill it in.
Now, do owls have coloured eyes?
I don't know.
I imagine owls have brown eyes for some reason. I don't know why. But I think you could also do that a different colour if you wanted to, couldn't you?
You could. Maybe even do a black centre and a different colour around the outside. Do all
Sheila's things. Messaged him. Oh, now her friend collects owls, so she's going to make one for her friend who collects owls. Oh, let us see it, Sheila, when you've made it. Okay. Oh, no. While you do that, because lots of people want to see the fabric, do you mind if I leave you while you just stitch
Not
that?
Not at all.
You can be all right.
Yes.
If you need any help, just give me a shout. I'm running back. This is the owl we're making. Look, here is. What name? What name would you give him? What name would you give that owl? I think he's lovely. We are using this fabric here, but let me take... I'm going to take them all off. Which one do you want to go to first, Hannah? Yeah, the one we're using. I'll show you this one. This is incredibly popular. I'm going to do a bit of wafting. Oh, isn't it lovely? So now, to make quite a few of these, you need half a metre of each of the fabrics. You could make a parliament. A parliament of owls. Yeah. So have a look at that. Isn't that lovely? This is Scenic Antique Garden Fabric by Makua. Now, for half a metre, £5.45, you're getting top quality cotton. Really beautiful cotton. I love that. I want that extension on my house. There, you see that kind of glass? I want one of those on my house. I might have to get some of this and take it to the builders. I love that design. Really, really gorgeous print. Now, remember, it's £5.45 for half a metre. Now, the joy of Makua, I just think, apart from it being gorgeous fabric, is down the sides, they have all the colours that are in the design. Now, then the numbers don't mean anything. It just means that one's got 17 colours in it. But if you wanted to match it with another fabric or with a threads or a solid fabric or anything like that, then all the colours that have been used in that design are all down the side there. I love it. This is the most popular of the hour so far. Really beautiful. Gorgeous. It looks, there it is. There's the extension that I want in my house. That's very nice. I'll just put that back there. Height of summer. This is lovely. Now, this, I'd use this for something in the kitchen, like an apron or oven gloves or oven mitts or something like that. Well, let me open it out for you. Because you're going to cook a lot of it. It's got vegetables on it, hasn't it, as well as garden things. Let's have a look. There's honey there. Oh, yes. I haven't got my glasses on. I was convinced I could see vegetables on there. No, I wouldn't eat bulbs. But it would look, wouldn't that look lovely in your kitchen, wouldn't it, Jo?
It would, really
lovely.
Thank
you. The expert says yes. Oh, look, there's here. Oh, look, you could team it with the bike. Look, there's a bicycle there. You could team it with the bicycle. Isn't that lovely? Really beautiful. I think that's gorgeous. Now, Hannah says conservatory cushions, or she'd make a, I don't know what I'm doing that. When you go do your gardening and you kneel down and you want to... It's called a kneeler, I think, isn't it? Rather than just a cushion. A kneeling pad. That'd be lovely because it's machine washable, this fabric. So you could make it out of that. Now, look at this. We love this. We love, 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 love this. Right, ready? Waft. Isn't that gorgeous? I mean, the quality is out of this world. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful fabric here. This is the blue bicycles. Second most popular fabric of the day today. That is just stunning. What would you make out of that, Hannah? Oh, she's getting very creative. For her bicycle has got a front basket on it. She would make a lining, and the lining would go over the top of the basket. Oh, she's changed her mind now. A seat cover for a bicycle seat. Nobody's going to see it, though, Hannah. Apart from when it's parked up, exactly. I think they're beautiful. I think they're absolutely gorgeous. Do you know what? This would look lovely in a because the colours within it and the flowers and everything would look gorgeous in a conservatory, wouldn't it, as well? Really, really beautiful. OK, now the other fabric that we're using to make the owl, Brian the owl, or... not Hannah the owl, that's a boy, Hannah. Is this linen effect fabric. This is very clever because it looks like a linen... Looks like a linen, but it doesn't, like Joe was saying, the linen phrase, and when you work with it, crease and everything. This is the gorgeous fabric, cotton fabric by Macauer, half a metre, £4.95, but it's got the linen texture to it. It's not actually linen. Now, they call it coral, right, but we would definitely call it a pale terracotta. That's the colour we would call that. Now, two fabrics that have been kind of... We haven't really shown them very much today, and I love these. They're the daisy prints that I've got here. Let me just put that back nicely. These daisy prints are just gorgeous. Look, it's like an all-over print. Do you know what? Well, you could make it all over the house, but do you know what? Make a lovely summer frock. It's a really, really good quality cotton. Make a lovely, lovely, lovely summer frock. Or a blouse, or a sleeveless blouse. With a tie front, I'm thinking. £5.45 for half a metre. It is lovely. It's classic. And it says, you know what? Use it as trim. Use it as trim for something. That's really nice. That's the blue one. And then last but not least, we will go back to the owl in a second, don't we? Last but not least, we've got the green one here. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful green one. I'd say it was more of a... pale khaki or kiwi fruit green. They've obviously used, the colours are from the rest of the collection, if you see. They are from the rest of the collection. They all tone in so nice with each other. That is the Green Daisy Antique Garden Fabric, half a metre for £5.45. OK, going back now to Joe, because we need to finish that owl before. Now, remember, if you've got a name for the owl, just let us know. How are you getting on there? Oh.
OK, for the sake of time, I'm going to leave...
Oh, yes.
Is that okay?
Absolutely.
Skip on.
One eye. We haven't done... We've only embroidered one eye. We haven't embroidered the other eye. Because we need to get the wings on and the body made.
I do. So, checking which way the wings...
You've got 13 minutes. You've got plenty of time, don't
you? Is that okay? Yeah. I can go back to that at the end.
Exactly.
So, using the mark we made before, that's...
That's the bottom of the wing.
The bottom of the wings.
You only did one mark, didn't you?
Did. And then I'd baste these on.
OK,
just so they're held in place. So I'll do
the fabric we use there for the wings and for the head, for the face, is Scenic Antique Garden. Scenic Antique Garden fabric. £5.45 for half a metre. It's lovely, isn't it? Really, really good. Hello. Oh, no, I don't think owls would speak like that, would they? Hello. Hello. I think an owl would speak like that, don't you?
It would. An air of superiority, I think, an owl.
Do what?
They'd have an air of superiority.
Oh, OK. Thank you. You say no, it's an air of superiority.
No. Am I taking this too seriously?
No, not at all. We love it. We love it. And you're loving it as well. You're loving seeing Jo making all her soft toys. We've got the Owl Hour. Right. Oh, well, it's nearly finished now. It's flown by, hasn't it? Where we're making this gorgeous owl out of the Macauer fabrics. We've got the Scenic Antique Garden fabric on the face there, and then the Linen Effect fabric, which is one down there, the coral at the bottom. OK, so we've basted the wings in place.
The wings are in place, and then I'm going to fold the bottom to find the centre.
Has the tail gone the front?
Well, it... could go on the back as well.
Okay.
But I like to just put everything on the one piece. And now to check, you want the tail to go right side facing up so that when it's assembled, it will be the right way up.
Yeah, perfect.
Could you tell I wasn't quite sure then? Yes, and I double-checked them.
No, it's always best to double-check, isn't it? OK, you're going to base that in
I'm going to base that on, yeah.
OK, we'll just watch Joe do that.
OK. And then I'm going to attach the back piece. But first of all, to keep these out of the way so they don't get caught in any seams, I'm just going to pin them.
Oh, yes, yes, of course.
Inwards. That way. And I found the safest way to pin is the pins pointing that way. Otherwise, you can catch your fingers on them later during bagging out. That's from experience.
Yes, Anna hasn't stopped talking all the time you've done it.
OK.
So yes, right.
I'll sew it. It needs to be sewn to the top. We're making a loop. So I'll sew onto the top and the bottom now.
I'm just intrigued how your mind works.
Hang on, I've done this too soon.
Oh, okay.
I need to sew this on first, otherwise I might get a fold in that.
Okay, yeah.
I'm running ahead.
I'm intrigued how your mind works, though. I wouldn't even know that it would be a loop, do you know what I mean? I would think it'd be a front and a back and not a loop round sort of thing.
The easiest way to come up with any pattern is draw it first, and often you see things in the drawing ways that to...
Well, I suppose it's only the same as when a designer, when I was a maker, making costumes, everything, a designer would give you a design and you'd go, oh, well, actually, that won't work because this actually needs to be here and this seam needs to go like that. And you can envisage the pattern from seeing a drawing of the actual dress or whatever.
Yes. For me, the better the drawing I've done at the beginning, the better the first attempt always turns out.
Okay, that's interesting.
So now I'm going to go back and pin these in. Like that, and then...
So now you're going to make your...
Loop it over and sew this together at the bottom.
Okay. You're loving the fabric. Which one? This the one that the Scenic Garden one. Very, very popular. You can see it on the owl, on the owl's head there. Now, Anna's saying, could you put rice or something heavy inside him if you want to make him a little doorstop?
You could, because he's got a square base and he sits nicely.
Oh, yes, we better get the square base sorted, didn't we?
Oh, I have. Right, so I'll just show. So now it's a loop, but we want to reposition the fabric and sew them together so he forms... So the fold... So, yeah. In this, is at the top.
Yes.
And we made the mark earlier. I'm going to open the seam out.
Well, Diane's loving all the guest experts. We're a very hard-working team, she says. Well, they are, not me, yeah.
So lining up this seam with the mark we made earlier. So I'll pop a pin in.
Oh, the owl should be called Little John. Because it's wide. Oh, wow. She said it could be called Little John because it's wise. I thought she said it should be called Little John because he's wide.
Right, and I'm going to sew down one side completely, and the other one will have to have the space, the opening to turn it right side out. There's no obvious way, place to have. Normally, I like to put it in the base or the back. But with this, because we've got the tail in the back seam and we're going to box the bottom corners, the most...
Oh, yes, the only place would be there and you wouldn't want it on there, would you?
No, so it's...
Oh, no, you're right. Well, of course you're right, you're the expert.
It's under one ear.
Right, we've got 5 minutes.
Right, I would give this a little press.
Yes, of course.
Just so we have the folds in the right place, but I'm just going to go for it. This here, I'll pop a pin in. Now, I only sew the top half inch, maybe, if that. It makes it easy when you're closing not to close right up to the corner.
Oh, yes,
for the corner to be already formed.
And you don't want to close, you keep going, you don't want to bag out where the wing is.
No.
Because you don't want that bulk and everything in the seam. I just did the wing, where the wing is, like that. Yes. I'm a wide, broken-winged owl called Little John.
I couldn't make the stag the other day without doing antlers either.
Oh, Jenny wants to call the owl George after her dad because he loved owls. Thank you, Jenny. That's nice. That's lovely. What are you waving for, Jay? No, Jay thinks he's that. Jay thinks he is an owl. He's just flapping his little wings. Jay's our floor manager, if you didn't know today.
So you want to sew just beyond the wing so you're not having to close on a wing.
Of course, yes.
So leaving a space. Move that pin. I would press this just to make it easier to sew.
Yes.
But, and then, I'll give it a good finger press so I can see the crease.
Yeah, on at home, you won't be rushed to within an hour to make it on. It's just less than now. And you wouldn't have me hassling you all the times. I'm going to get the blame for this. You do know that. It's not your fault.
So we want the crease in the bottom that we've just pressed, so the centre crease, to line up with the side seam if we open a pin through.
So you're creating this squared off bottom now then?
Yes, and it's easier if the seam is open and if you use a ruler.
It is going good.
And then you want to sew just above there, straight across.
Okay.
I would mark it on, but...
Of course, just do that then. Just so you know, this scenic garden fabric that we're using for the head, limited stock, limited stock. The stock has nearly gone. So just to warn you, the stock of this has nearly gone. I will go through all the other fabrics in a second for you. There are other options, but just so you know, I'm not adding any undue pressure. Just don't want you to ring up and then say, oh, no, I'm sorry, it's all gone now. If you want that, give us a call.
See the other one?
What have you stuffed this one with then?
Just polyester toy filling.
Oh, okay. Got that.
It's a really nice filling that. So they can be really different toy fillings. Some feel nice and fluffy, but when you put them in, there's no spring and it just sits in there like a stone. So you want a nice springy.
£2.95, the toy filling slash stuffing, 250 grams. £2.95. Safety first. Right, OK. Oh, now.
I am going particularly quickly. I would snip those off and I would also zigzag just out of habit.
So it doesn't wear away.
And then from there...
So that's him, really, once you've bagged him through.
It
what's,
is.
What's the pin?
I'm going to take the pins out if I can. Before I turn it, because it hurts if you don't. There we go, have I got it? There we go.
Okay, now we're just changing the graphics because that fabric is nearly sold out. One of the options is this really lovely scatter. It's called the scatter print. There, isn't that lovely? The scatter antique garden fabric, same range. That'll work just, just as beautifully, but the one that Joe's used has nearly sold out. Don't want anyone to be disappointed. Excuse them, well. So you bagged him out.
Bagged him out, and then it's just a case of filling the owl, and then...
And slipping up the side there.
Closing the...
And finishing the last eye as well. A bit of a deflated little John there. But once he's stuffed and had the eye finished, that's perfect. That's brilliant, isn't it? And his wings will come out there. He does look a bit like me, doesn't he? Right, Joe, you're back in an hour's time.
I am.
Oh, with, it's called Simple Softies.
Simple Softies,
Simple
yes.
Softies. Right, oh, now, thank you so much,
Thank
Steve.
You.
Have a look at all the fabric we've got available. Now, I'm coming over to it here. Starting off, here we go, this is the scatter. This is the scatter antique garden fabric, half a metre, for £5.45. Absolutely beautiful. Now, this one is selling, the one next door that you've seen Joe using, that one is about to sell out. So if you wanted an alternative, then this one is beautiful, isn't it? At £5.45 for half a metre. You made lots with it. We had lots and lots of different ideas, didn't we? About aprons and kneeling pads and everything like that. Well, of course, you could use it for the owl. Okay, the bicycle one. The bicycle one is just gorgeous, isn't it? Second most popular one today. Really, really lovely print there. That's like an antique bike, or very old bikes, isn't it? Really lovely. With the blue bicycle antique fabric on there as well. Now, you know that Jo has been making that owl from her own design, but we also have this lovely crafting springtime gift book by Tilda, which also comes with lots of animal designs. Be great, absolutely great with all of these. Oh, there you go, all these fabrics. What was a duck? Is that a duck? Goose. We'll look at these a bit closer in one of the other shows, but just so you know, that's available there. That is, oh, how much is it? Sorry, Hannah. £7.95. £7.95. It is the crafting springtime gift. Now, go nowhere, because Sammy's back up again now. Now, she's making some very, very unusual shaped cushions, but out of really beautiful Pandalicious fabric. Now, you might have seen it the other day with me, but we've got something slightly different, a much heavier weight. Don't go anywhere. Go and make yourself a cup of tea. We will see you in 3 minutes from now, where we're going to make these really lovely piped triangular cushions. Go nowhere. When you spend £10 on your first purchase, you will receive this free sewing kit from the Sewing Quarter worth £14.99.
Join us on Friday the 17th, where we'll be showcasing ideas for the Very Hungry Caterpillar with guest designer Jo Carter. 8 a.m, how to make a baby changing bag. 10 a.m, create your very own baby cot quilt. Make sure you don't miss out.
Here at the Sewing Quarter, we want to help you with your levels of sewing. Whether you're a novice or you've been sewing for years and years, we want this to be a fabulous learning curve for all of you. Whether it's making a little gift or making yourself a fabulous outfit, we will be working with some of the UK's biggest designers. You have to join us for that.
Don't forget, our sister brands are some of the leading brands in the industry, with Love Patchwork and Quilting being rated top modern quilt title on the market. Today's quilter has achieved market leadership in the traditional quilt sector. And finally, Simply Sewing was launched in February 2015 after noticing a gap in the market for beginners. Combined, we reach over 150,000 readers every month.
I would describe Sewing Quarter as encouraging, inspiring, fun, friendly, and fresh. I'm just really excited about getting started and designing and just coming up, letting the ideas flow and coming up with ideas to show on screen. The preparation that's gone into the show so far has been things like experimenting with fabric, lots of chopping up and experimenting with fabrics together, and lots of sketching in sketchbooks, things like that. If I had one fat quarter and half an hour, I would probably make some sort of zip pouch. I'm a sucker for zip pouches in my handbag that have various bits of makeup, bits of sewing kit, that sort of thing in. What will surprise you about Sewing Quarter? I think, really, it's how much freedom and scope we're given as designers to just go with whatever ideas come to us, and it's really encouraging, and it's a great place to work.
Hello, welcome back. Now, look at this. Have you ever seen a triangular cushion before? No? I have neither. Then I said to Hayley, who's our production manager, I said, oh, triangular cushion. She went, oh, my house is full of them. So I was like, oh, OK, I'll take that back. I think it's fantastic. Very good for lounging, apparently. What lovely fabric. Now, Sammy's back to show us how to make this cushion, but I'm just going to take you through the fabrics before we do, because you might have seen this Pandalicious print before. I've got it in the cotton here, but this is like a much heavier weight to make the cushion out of it. It's really lovely, isn't it? Really good, gorgeous. OK, so let me put that down. I'll quickly go. That's the canvas one, but I'll take you through what... Oh, you want the canvas one first. OK, then. Okay, here we go. Oh, now there you go. Now, is this fabric feels wider? What's the width of this fabric then, Hannah? Oh yes, it's definitely wider. Look, that's lovely, isn't it? So this is the canvas fabric. This is the one that we will be using to make the cushions with. That's £8.95 for half a metre. Good quality. It's a lot. Oh, I'll talk to Sammy about that in a second, about the quality. Feels amazing. I'm going to have to put it down. My arms are aching. I will get the width of that for you in a second, because that's definitely wider than our other fabrics. If you love that, if you love that canvas, but you want it in a cotton, a straightforward cotton, 100% cotton, we do have it in the 100% cotton as well here. So if you wanted to make a shirt or a blouse or anything a little bit lighter weight, then we've got the same pattern. Excuse me, it's called the Pandalings Pod, a pod assured fabric. This is £7.95 for half a metre. So now you can either ring the call centre and they'll help you with it, saying you either want the cotton one or the canvas one, or just jot down the code. Excuse me. Just jot down the code number there for you, the code, and you can check it out on the web. These two are just gorgeous. Look at these. These are fabulous. These are, look, I'll open the whole thing out. It's just beautiful. We absolutely love this. This one's called Recess, as in American playtime, you know, at school, recess. It's just gorgeous. The pandas are having so much fun, aren't they? £7.95 for half a metre again. Now, this is lovely for blouses, for skirts, for all sorts of things. We'll ask Sammy afterwards what else she would make out of this. You could use it for the cushion as well if you wanted to. Maybe put some Vylene on the back or something like that. But we'll talk about that later. But that is gorgeous. Do you know what? That would make a lovely a curtain for a summer room, or blinds in your conservatory or something like that, wouldn't it? Just a very, very versatile fabric. That's lovely, with the gorgeous teals and greens at the back. But we also do another panda fabric along the same lines. Still Panda Garden, but this time, is it called Nap Time, this one? I think this one's Having a Nap, I think this one is called. See? Nap Time, Having a Nap. Isn't that? I love this one. Now, this is the one we all decided that... Chrissy emailed in, didn't she, the other day, saying she was going to make me a shirt. And we all decided that we should make it out of this fabric for me. £7.95 for half a metre. Again, look at all the print. It's such a fabulous, fabulous print there. £7. This is our Panda Pals advert, I was going to say that. Our Panda Pals hour. £7.95 for that gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous Nap Time fabric there. By Art Gallery. By Art Gallery. Now, I need to also tell you that we've just got a few... Oh, no, I forgot. I forgot a one. It was hiding. It was hiding. Sammy's favourite. This is lovely, because the pandas are hiding on this one. Oops, this one's called Cotton Bud, I think, this one, isn't it? Oh, somebody's been chopping away at this, Jay. Somebody's obviously made something, I think. No, because it's been chopped at the... No, that's half metre you get. That's half metre you get. But look, don't they... Look, they're hiding. Can you see them? Look. Oh, it is cotton bud. Blimey, I'm surprising myself today. £7.95. Oh, so that's what you'll get for £7.95. That's what you'll get for £7.95. Half a metre. It's beautiful. Absolutely gorgeous, isn't it? Cute. That's Sammy's favourite one. Now, we've also got the... I just have to get this, because this is the one I think we've used as the binding. I'll just put this back up here and Jay can come in and tidy up in a second. We've got the solid colours as well. We've got the beautiful, beautiful solid colour as well. There, isn't that a lovely colour? It's like a petrol-y blue, isn't it? Oh, marine blue. All right, marine blue. This is from our Spectrum range. We've got lots and lots of different colours on the web. £3.25 for half a metre. Fabulous for your stash. Sammy's used this as her piping on the cushions. Then very quickly, I've got a couple of others to show you. Yeah, there we go. I think this one must be slate grey, is it? I'm making up the colour names now. We'll just double check for a second. Oh, charcoal. Charcoal, that one. Very nice. £3.25 for half a metre there. It's very good quality. Lots of you come in and buy this, just have it in your stash. What colour are you going to now? Oh, aqua. Oh, this is nice. Lovely. There's loads of them, aren't there? I'll just show them very quickly. This is the aqua. You could team all of these, because the black and white, everything's going to go with black and white. And they've chosen this one, obviously, because this one will go so beautifully with the two panda fabrics, wouldn't they, as well? £3.25 for half a metre. And then we've got grass. Oh, it's nice. Nice colour. Very fresh. That's a very, very fresh colour, isn't it? That one's called grass. Lovely green there. It's got lots of yellow in that one. It's a really lovely green. If you were doing paints, it would be green mixed. Oh, excuse me. Forest green mixed with yellow, I'd say that one was. I'll have a slurp of my water in it, don't worry. And then last but not least, I've got it in black. If you want the black to go with the Pandalicious or with your stash, then this is always perfect to have, isn't it? At £3.25 for half a metre. Okay, graphics up, coming in. Okay, right, now I know you don't want to see me anymore. You want to see Sammy and her cushion project. So we'll pop over. Hello again.
Hello.
This is fantastic. I hadn't even seen a triangular cushion before.
Oh, thank you. I really like them. I like it because we were talking before in the office outside how they'd be great if you've got a corner sofa that you kind of always get a bit stuck in. You wedge it in the corner of the sofa and then lean up against it.
We've got one of those in the green room.
Yeah.
We could practice later.
We could. We will. That's where they're going to go. They're so cute, aren't they?
Now, first of all, the fabric is beautiful, isn't it?
It really is.
Lovely fabric. But it's kind of a canvassy fabric, this one, isn't it?
It is. Art Gallery do quite a few of these. There's a couple that we've got in, but it's really, although, because sometimes when you think of canvas, it's really stiff.
Yes,
and
you
hard.
Think of, yes, yeah.
And obviously, that's good for some things, but this stuff is so soft. It's a really gorgeous weave. It's really soft and smooth. And look, I've just scrunched that and it's smoothed out beautifully.
But hard wearing as well, obviously.
Yeah, absolutely. Really hard because it is that slightly thicker fabric. But it's soft, you know, scrunchy and cuddly, so you feel like you can cuddle up against it.
So we're saying it's canvas, but don't think one of those. I always think of my dad was in the RAF, and when he used to go away, he'd have this canvas bag, and it was so rigid.
Yeah, hard
canvas,
and stiff, but that's not at all what the art galleries are like. They're very, very soft and pliable and very easy to sew.
Oh, that's the most important thing. Yeah. Did you have to change your needle for it?
I would have used, I use a 90 most of the time anyway, but I would definitely use a 90 with this one. But you don't need to use anything thicker because although it is thicker, it's not stiffer, which again, you know, going through lots of layers on the corners, it's helpful to have a slightly heavier needle.
Okay, brilliant. So, show us how to make a triangular cushion.
All right. Oh, we've got on the other side.
Watch my display. Thank you.
We're going to start by cutting out our triangles.
Right. Now, it's not with a pattern, is it?
So, no.
If the people at home would like to know what measurements you've used, they can ring the call centre, can't they?
They can. Tell us now, I'm going to tell you that. Well, for the large one that we've done here, again, all you need to make sure is that all of your triangles are reasonably the same. Obviously, the more identical you can get them, the better.
Right.
If you're cutting them all out at the same time, that's perfect.
Oh, yes.
I've made it actually so that the base triangle is an equilateral triangle, so it's equal all the sides. And the ones on the side are a slightly isoseles triangle.
Isoseles triangle. Oh, so you have got different shapes.
Yeah, same size at the base. And then actually this one is, these are all the same size.
Oh, okay.
But the bigger one is slightly more tall than it is wide at the base.
Yes.
And obviously this is, it's not a pyramid. I can't remember, I did look up what it's called. But obviously because this is a triangular base, not a square base.
Oh,
so a square base is a pyramid. So you've got,
so a pyramid's got four sides.
Yeah, which obviously you can do as well.
Oh, yeah, you know, but you'd have a square on the bottom.
But you'd have a square on the bottom rather than,
So let me just pick that up. So that's because triangle. Oh.
Yeah, triangle.
Okay, right.
So that's the one we've done. So we're going to cut out some triangles.
So now if you know the name of it, it's not a pyramid because it's only got, it's got a special name, has it?
Yeah, it's got a different name. Triangular.
If you know it, let us know. I want to say rhomboid, but that's something must be something completely different.
That's a square something or other. I don't quite know.
That's what? Sorry. Nothing. Okay. Right.
There we go.
So to make this big one,
yes.
How much fabric do you think you need?
I think I used a metre, but you would have enough because you've got to do four triangles, and obviously this is directional fabric.
Oh, of course.
Obviously, if you want to do the bottom one, you could do that in a different
angle,
fabric or something. Or a different
fabric, exactly.
Yes, you could put I was going to put some of the plain on the bottom, but I thought, I had enough, so I used this.
So a metre?
Yes, I used a metre.
Tetrahedron, was that the word you were looking for?
Probably.
OK, so So I'll let you
we're
cut
just,
today.
I'm not going to actually cut today because we've got a couple cut out already,
okay,
I don't think. But basically, you would mark out your triangle by your measurements, and then you would use your cutting mat and your
rotary cutter.
I keep calling it by its brand name. Sorry.
Oh.
It's and just follow the lines. This is easy to mark on as well. On the back.
We speak student.
Sewing quarter 3D. Ruler here. The lovely sewing quarter ruler. So how big? Have you got a note there of how big these triangles are?
I did, but I left it outside.
Oh, okay. Don't worry.
It's they're 40. It was 45 centimetres.
Yes.
By 48 centimetres.
Okay, so it's only a little bit longer than this is wider.
Yeah, not much. It didn't take much to get it a little bit bigger.
So 45 across the bottom, the two sides are 48, and then the one on the bottom is obviously all 45.
Yes.
Okay, brilliant. And that includes your seam allowance.
On the bottom, yes.
Brilliant.
So, but then again, obviously, you can make them even bigger. We were talking about having one of these and putting beanbag fill in the bottom.
Oh, yes,
and making it into a beanbag, or, like we did with the big round cushion the other day, using it as extra bedding storage.
Oh, yes.
So
that
you could scale
fantastic
it up
idea.
And make it huge, and then roll your duvet up and put it inside, put it in the kids' room and spare duvets and stuff going there.
Yeah, so they can use it as a cushion all the time until they have mates to stay, and then there's your duvet, not taking up space in your wardrobe or your cupboard,
indeed.
Your linen cupboard.
Okay, I've got little ones to start with, but that's how they're going to look when you finish. So they should.
Okay, so the little, we're starting with the little one.
Although I'm doing a bigger one.
Oh, you're doing the bigger one as well?
Apparently, I just don't have one actually cut out on its own.
Oh, okay, but so we'll come to the smaller one in a second then.
Yes, that's fine. So this is what you're going to end up with. You're going to end up with triangles that all point in the same direction.
Okay.
And you're going to cut out, as I said, three of those and then one to go on the bottom.
Okay. So what have you done? Yes, there's four triangles in total. One, the one at the bottom is the same measurements to three sides. And the two, that one's 45 by 45 by 45. The ones going up the side are 45 across the bottom, two sides of 48.
I'll get them to put the measurements that I've got outside on the Facebook page later.
Okay,
people
brilliant.
People can look at it. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to put all those to one side for a moment and we're going to cut the binding.
Right.
I've done straight binding on this because it's not going around any corners.
Okay, now if you were to put a piping cord in it, you'd have done it on the bias.
I would, because obviously it's going to be going round, but obviously this is just a straight one. We haven't put any cord in here at all. Again, I think sometimes you don't always have to worry about it.
No, but also if you've got children that are going to sleep on it, sometimes you don't want the piping cord because that's going to be squidgy on their face, isn't it?
Yes, again, similar to the reason we didn't put a button on the one the other day, because we want to have, nice, soft and squidgy, like you say, to squidge up against. So, again, this is another really good reason for using the longer ruler.
Yeah.
Is that obviously you can just...
Oh, you've got the whole width of the fabric. Exactly.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm just going to move this round.
Okay.
And stand on my tippy toes again, because I'm a shorty.
I thought you were wearing high heels today.
No, not today. Should have.
I don't need high heels because I'd just tower above you if I wore high heels. So we're using here the sewing quarter ruler. Oh, there it is, £13.95.
So I'm going to use the ruler to do my measuring for me.
Right.
And I'm going to line it up and we're going to make these 2 inches. Sorry, I'm swapping backwards and forwards today. 5 centimetres.
Yes.
2 inches,
yeah.
Just a straight strip. So I'm just going to keep cutting straight down.
Oh, okay.
So I am going to do this. I'm going to put my finger on the edge. There we go.
Now, the rotary cutter, that's that 45mm rotary cutter you're using there.
Yes.
Put the safety catch away. And then also on the... Obviously, only use the rotary cutter on a cutting mat, a self-healing cutting mat.
Yep. So I cut... this is obviously quite wide enough to do each side. So I cut 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 strips.
Yes.
So 3 strips. But cut a little bit extra just in case.
Oh, always.
And then we're just going to sew it in half... Basically, we're not going to do it. We're not again. If when you're doing piping or anything like that, you don't have to worry about stitching it and then turning it through, because obviously what you want to create is you want to create a flange. So I'm just going to fold it in half and then stitch down quite close to the edge, just to create so it holds it together. Basically,
okay.
So that we don't have to worry about holding it together whilst we're stitching it between two layers of fabric.
But you wouldn't press it, you wouldn't press the seam in at this point?
No, because I kind of don't want it to be too sharp.
Okay.
Because I want it to be slightly kind of softer and rounded, so I wouldn't iron it. I would just hold it, maybe pin it if you want to, or you can clip it. But I'm just going to wing it, because that's what I'm like.
This is the marine blue that we're using here, or Sammy's using here, to make the binding with. Really, really lovely colour. It's got a kind of kingfisher feel to it, but it's at £3.25 for half a metre, remember, from the Spectrum Solid of Macau. If you go through to our website, if the colours that we've got here today aren't right for you, go through to the website, you will see all the different colours that we do.
You can see I'm just folding it as I go, and actually I was doing this the other day and I realised that it's probably quite a good tip for people doing things like this. I pop my two fingers on either side.
Right.
You can probably see.
Yeah, we can see that.
Like that. Yeah. And I use this finger just to lightly guide it, and then I put my hand down here, which I don't think you can see with the camera,
graphics in.
If I lift it up there. So I'm holding this and folding it in half with my fingers.
Oh, okay.
As I go.
Yes,
so if you've got lots of length of binding to do and you don't, like, for instance, if you're doing bunting,
yes,
and you've got lots of length of binding to do and you don't want to pop pins in, like, all the way down because you're going to catch them as they're feeding through, this is a good way to do it so that you don't have to pin. So you're folding as you're going and your two fingers, you can see there, are guiding me.
Oh, yes.
If I lift that up so that I know if I feel like it's going off or if I feel like it's getting too wide, you know, they're kind of... Again, it's kind of one of those instinctive things that I don't really think about, the fact that I'm doing that, but I realise that some people may not.
Yeah, but it's like having your own natural binding maker, isn't it?
Well, absolutely.
That's exactly what the binding maker would do.
Particularly with straight binding, because obviously you don't really want to put that through a bias binding maker. Put my foot down, we get to the end.
We're in that Coronation Street knicker factory, aren't we, going at that speed? It just always amazes me. I mean, I know they do stitch fast in real knicker factories, but or any factories
fast
like that. But they kind of seem to be able to do it and chat at the same time.
Yeah.
You know?
There we go.
I know they're actors, but they have to know your art. So they might be method, darling. Right. So
lovely. So there you go. So that's just basically we just stitched it in half. Again, I quite like the fact that it kind of is
bounces back.
Yeah. Yes. Obviously, if you wanted to put a piping cord in there to make it a little bit more rounded, you could.
Yes. We'll do how to make piping and make piping in a day, because you need a special foot on the machine and everything for that, don't you?
Yes.
We thought this would be good we will be doing that.
I have a show planned with piping, with how to do it with a zipper foot and the piping foot.
Brilliant.
That is coming. It's just not yet.
Right.
So that's just ordinary piping. So we're gonna. When you've done that, you want to sandwich it between your layers. You can see down the edge here, I just quickly, because again, this canvas, you can see it frays quite easily. So I wanted to make sure, so I've just done a line of tacking stitches very close to the edge of the fabric, just to stop it from fraying out too far.
Or stay stitches, some people call
that. Yes, stay stitching, yes. So I've done that. You could do a double row if you felt like it was fraying out a lot. Again, because we're cutting this not straight.
Yes, on the bias, yeah.
You're going to get lots of little ends coming off as you go. And
might
obviously, again...
Might you cut it with
pinking shears? Yes, but this is such a loose weave.
I'm
not sure it's going to make that much difference.
Yeah.
Pinking shears are great on lighter weight cottons, particularly for stopping things from fraying. But with looser weave and with things like boucle and, you know, woven like Chanel tweeds and things like that, they're not going to make that much difference.
Yeah.
So this is quite loose, so I wouldn't worry.
Okay.
Stay stitching is probably quicker.
Oh, no, no,
than
totally.
Having to worry about pinking
shears. Totally, yeah.
So what I did here is that I stitched it down one side first to keep it in place so that I didn't have to worry about when I'm sandwiching.
Of course, yes.
I've got three pieces, not just two. I had to pin, you have to pin one side, do it, and then pin the next side and do it. So, as I said, I stitched it first, and then I wanted to show this piece at the top here because I think people will be interested to see. You know when we did mitering the other day?
Yes.
I've done the same thing. So when I get to the top... A little bit wiggly there. when I got to the top, I've then gone to the point rather than going straight off the edge. Like you can see the stitching on the binding goes straight. I've kind of veered off to the point.
Yes.
So that when we peel that back and do the next one, you're going to get a reasonably neat finish at the top. Because
of
obviously
course.
We've got lots of layers and you can see I've pushed them all in the same direction.
Yeah.
So again, with the next one we put on, we would do it in the same direction. Again, that's how you get this neater looking top section. So they all kind of fold in. There's not a very much easier way of getting that to fold in.
Exactly.
But if you do it all in one direction.
And also not using piping, because three lots of piping all around, it's going to be a very clumpy top there, isn't it? Whereas this is still a soft, squidgy top there, even though you've got the three bindings going in there.
Yeah, it doesn't make it too bulky. So it still looks triangular rather than looking rounded at the top.
Yeah, yeah, because if it was... Yes, exactly.
All righty.
So you've done...
So I sew one in place, and then I trim... Again, I trim them as I went, so that I didn't have too much excess. And obviously, we're going to have, again, quite a lot of bulk at the top here.
Yeah.
So trimming them off at that, the angle of the previous one... There we go. Yeah. Should, again, help reduce that bulk. It means you don't have to cut through lots of layers when you've turned it through the other way. So that's fine. So then you would just place the next layer on top. Again, stitch down the side, being careful.
So you literally just... So you put that in place and you sandwich...
Yes.
...that between the two...
Yes.
...remembering to keep your pandas all facing in the same
direction.
Yes,
these are not, because these are the offcuts.
Oh, okay.
My other one over here has them all facing the right way. But yes, so yeah, make sure your pandas are facing to the point, not the other way.
To the point.
And yes, make sure... And obviously, when I do this, rather than using pins, because we're using... thicker fabric, I've used the Wonder Clips.
Oh, okay.
As we go. So you would just use these gorgeous little... I love these because they're bright lime green.
They're amazing, aren't they?
You can pin them over the edge, and because you've got a slightly thicker... If I was to pin through that, which I'll show you now, with a glass-headed pin, what you're going to get is it's going to buckle up a little bit.
And also, not everybody's pins are as sturdy as these lovely pins that we've got here, and they could bend, couldn't they,
and go through. And if you pin the other way, you can see it just gives you a little bit of that bump, whereas the clips don't do that.
No.
They just give you that really smooth finish. And because we're doing something triangular, we want to make sure that all the points match up beautifully,
and neatly. And with them being all on the bias, they could easily stretch
and pull out of shape.
Now, we've already taken a couple out of here. Don't worry, yours will have all 10 in the packet. These are the Clover Wonder Clips. There are 10 of them for £7.95. Yours will come really beautifully packaged. Have I got one? Oh, I've got one, actually.
You have.
I've got one there. So I was going to take yours away. There you go. You see, it all comes beautifully packaged up with them all in the pack there. 10 of them for £7.95. Really lovely. If you want other sizes, there are other sizes of Wonder Clips on the web. So where are we up to with this, then?
So this is all three sewn together. So I sew the top three together first.
Right.
So now we've got, you can see, a nice inside-out pyramid.
OK, well, except it's not a pyramid.
It's not a pyramid.
What's it called, Michael? Michael had...
Tetrahedron. I'm not a mathematician, I'm a sewer.
Neither's Mike. I think he's got Google on his phone or something.
So you can see there what that's going to look like. So all of this is sandwiched in here.
Looks like a deflated umbrella, doesn't
it?
Like a garden umbrella.
It's a bit sad, doesn't it? But that just, you know, again, it's a testament to how lovely and soft this fabric
is,
really.
Yes, no, totally.
And again, you can see the binding's been squished a little bit because obviously we've been sandwiching it in between. So you can always give that a quick iron back if you want it to be puffed, or it has kind of a finger press.
I think it looks nice, the way it folds.
Quite nice. So that's
so this is going to be intriguing now, how you put the bottom on.
We're going to put a zip in as well.
Oh, are we?
We are.
Oh, sorry, I missed that completely.
There we are.
Oh, so it's got a hidden zip along one of the seams.
It has, because, you know, again, if you want to put something in, like a duvet or something, you want to be able to take it out. Kids' rooms, you want to be able to take it out.
Oh, and also you don't want to put that in your washing machine.
Spill a bit of tea. It's never going to dry out.
Oh, okay, so we've got a zip, have we?
Yes, we have. I've got a zip over here.
Oh, there you go. A nylon coil zip, 30 centimetres, £1.95. So you're going to make it even more difficult for yourself.
Tell me about it. So that's the top section done.
Yes.
And then like the one before, we're going to stitch the rest of the binding. This is my bottom section.
Yes.
And we're going to stitch it all the way around.
Right.
So we've stitched the binding all the way around the bottom section, all three sides rather than that, which we only did it up the middle section, which is lovely. And again, at the corners, you can see we've kind of got a little mitre going on here.
Okay, that's coming in now. There you go.
There we go. So we've done it up one side. This is all going to be hidden inside at the end.
Of course.
Okay, and the same with this one at this end. Again, I've stitched across and up to the point. So we've stitched along and up to the point, along and up to the point again, because it just gives you that, again, slightly easier when you're turning everything through.
Exactly. Now, if you just tuned in, this fabric here, it's a canvas fabric, Pandalicious Pandalings Pod canvas fabric from Art Gallery, £8.95 for half a metre. It's lovely soft canvas, but it's very, very durable, isn't it? Oh, there it is. That's the cushion we've made of it there. Sorry, I interrupted there.
No, that's fine. Alrighty, so then we're going to, I'm going to pin the zip in place. Oh, no, I'm not. I'm going to stitch this to it first. So I'm going to show a different technique for putting a zip in than I would normally.
Oh, okay.
And what we do is that we tack the seam first, then we sew the zip in, and then we unpick so that it is hidden underneath the two layers of fabric.
Why are you doing it differently today, then?
Because I wanted to show something different than I had done before.
Okay, brilliant.
To be fair, I think I did
very
this
risky.
I did this on the other floor cushion that I did the other day, but I didn't get to show the finish. Okay, so I wanted to get to show the finish.
Yeah, no, you're definitely going. Not even halfway through yet.
I know,
so you've definitely got time to show
racing
it today.
Away today. Right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the two base pieces and I'm going to stitch them.
So when you say tack, you don't mean tack by hand. You mean tack
by
machine.
No, I'm going to tack by machine with a long tacking stitch just because it's quicker.
Mm-hmm.
Although we're racing through today, so I could do it by hand.
No,
but we're going to do it by hand.
You've got a little one to make here yet as well.
I'm going
to
make the little one as well. That's fine.
Is there a zip in the little one?
I haven't put a zip in the little one, no.
I can make that one then. I'm not. You know how different sewists have different sleeves and zips are my two, or were my two bête noires, is that the right word? Or they just the thought of putting a sleeve in or the thought of putting a zip in just used to freak me out. So I'll let you get on.
No, righty. I'm just going to trim a little bit away because I think I made this one to match the other one. And I made this one a bit bigger.
For some reason.
Ooh. So if that happens.
I think Jay's on his way in.
If that happens and you find that the bottom piece that you have created is too big, I'll show you how to fix it as we have time. So I'm going to take this and I'm going to fold them all so that they're the two, one of them is folded in the middle there.
Like sandwiched, yeah?
Yeah, sandwiched in the middle. Try and get them, the bottoms lined up as much as I can. There we are. Obviously, I was cutting this one out in a hurry. Okay. So you can see, obviously, we've got seam allowance. We've got, this is going to be too narrow.
Yes.
So I'm just going to pop that on to where we need to get it, which is going to be about there. Pop it on that way. There we go. So you want to match up your line of stitching on this the side here with the line of stitching on the side here.
Yeah.
To where they fit on both sides, not just one. There we go. And I'm going to pop this on the other way around to where it all matches up. And then I'll take this away. And then very carefully, I might have to do this more than once, because we've got...
You're going through quite a few layers there, aren't
we
you?
We are, yeah, and particularly because it's the canvas, so... There we go.
There's the ruler that Sammy's using, £13.95. It's sewing quarter. It's a branded sewing quarter one, getting a lovely packaging. With the sewing quarter logo on and everything like that.
There we go. I'm just going to snip through the end here because this is too hefty for that. But it's been marked on the top layer, so I can do it one bit at a time.
Yes, because there's quite a few layers you're going through at the corner.
Well, yeah, we're going through like four layers of fabric and binding as well. There we go.
Brilliant.
So that if you have done your measurements wrong or if you've worked out sloppy cutting, apparently, like I was earlier today. There we go, so that's nice, and also sharpens up that edge at the bottom, so that's nice and neat now.
Yes.
There we go.
Perfect. So, you're now going to tack.
Yes, with a long machine stitch along the bottom of one of the sections. Doesn't matter which one.
Yeah.
Can be any one. See how nicely that matches up now?
Mm.
Perfect. That's what I should have done before. So I'm going to go to my machine. I'm going to put on the biggest stitch length possible, which on this one is a 5.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm just going to pop that through with some clips on because I do need this to be accurate.
Oh, okay.
Thank you.
How many will you need?
5, probably. There we go. Yeah, we want it to be... Thank you. We want it to be accurate because obviously this is going to be and straight. And obviously you've got lots of layers of fabric going on here because this is going to go down the centre of the zip. So we want it to be nice and neat and tidy and, as I say, as straight as possible. Thank you.
I've got six just in case.
Thanks. No, won't need that sixth one. Pop it on your shirt or something.
They can make nice decorations, these, don't they?
They would. I love the colour of these. I think they're amazing.
There they are. The Wonder Clip, £7.95. They are wonderful.
Okay, so again, I'm just going to double check and show you. So I've got the piping facing in towards the main fabric of the cushion.
Yeah.
And I'm going to pull this one out of the way.
Oh.
I'm not going to start straight in either. I'm going to start about a centimetre in. That's probably more like an inch, isn't it, really?
Yeah.
An inch in from the edge of the stitching.
Okay, this is just a tacking stitch, this one, isn't
it? Just a tacking stitch, and it's going to get unpicked afterwards.
Oh, okay.
To reveal the zip.
Ooh. So you're doing a live reveal.
I am.
It's very brave.
I know.
Okay, you're asking about the fabrics. I will go back in a second and show you the fabrics. We're just going to get this technique from Sammy, and then we'll go across.
I'm just going to show what this is going to look like afterwards, and then we'll put the zip in at the other side of looking at the fabrics. There we go. Okay, and again, I haven't stitched backwards and forwards or anything because I'm going to take it out. I haven't gone right to the end again because I'm going to take it out, so that's fine. So I'm just going to take that out of the machine gently so that I don't pull any of the stitches out.
Okay.
And when you turn that through, you should see that it's going to look almost like it's going to be when it's finished.
But yes.
You're going to put a zip in there? I am.
Okay.
Do you want to have a look at the fabrics first?
No, I want to watch you.
You want to do it now?
I'm more interested in this now.
So, where is my zip?
This
is
a long. Do you need me to go away?
No, that's fine. This is a longer zip than the one that I used in this one because that's all I had. But this is the same thing. This is just a longer version. I'm just going to trim the end off.
Right.
So we had a 30 centimetre zip. Yeah, there we go. So a lot of people think that you can't cut zips.
No.
But you can.
Well, you're just going to slice across it.
Yeah. So I'm measuring, using my mat here to measure, and I'm measuring the length of the teeth.
Yeah, so it's not so from the end there.
No, teeth are measured from the length of the...
The zips are measured from the top of the teeth.
Yeah, so top of the teeth. So I'm going to go to 30 here and then
now
I'm going to go to
30. Can you use your lovely scissors to do that?
Yeah, it's a nylon coil, so you're not cutting through any metal or anything. There we go. Drop it on the floor, Sammy. There we go. So all you need to make sure is that if you do this... before you pull your zip runner up and down, stitch across the end.
Oh, okay. I was wondering how you did that, yes.
I'm not going to because I'm going to stitch with my...
Because you're not going to open it.
No, absolutely. I'm going to leave it closed until we've got it into the fabric.
But still, don't you need to stitch the end up?
But yes, what I'm going to do now is that when I stitch this in, I'm going to stitch across...
Oh, shut up, John.
...down, across and up. So it's going to catch that end in when I stitch across at the end. And what we're going to do from the inside here, we want that to face upwards... I'm going to unflap everything. We may need the iron here.
The iron's ready, stand on standby.
Fabulous. Lovely. Right, okay. I'm going to open out this seam here. Making sure.
We need music, don't we, really? We need reveal music.
So I'm going to open out so that the seam.
Oh, that's just broken my dream. Hmm? I dreamt about us doing this last night.
No.
And the music was from the musical Smash.
Oh!
Don't forget me. You know the one where she's in the white dress at the end, like that?
Oh,
anyway,
my word.
Sorry. No, this is. I've got to concentrate.
Okay.
No, I wasn't singing. Just as well.
Lovely.
But it did wake me up.
So I'm making sure that. It's a bit hard to show, but. So I'm folding. This is the piping that's going to be on the outside. I'm folding that down towards the base.
Right.
And I'm folding it back. So it's kind of folded back on itself at this point.
So it's running along underneath this one. Is that's what you're saying, isn't it? It's underneath there. It's running right
absolutely.
Underneath the
so
seam
this is
lines.
Where we need to iron. So I'm just
going to
lift and scooch.
Another technical term there, lift and scooch.
Scooch.
That was a pop group, wasn't it, in Eurovision, Scooch.
Oh, yeah.
They did this, didn't they? They did Semaphore. Anyway, let's do yours. Let's
how
do this.
Funny.
This is my point.
Totally forgot about that.
Something all over the world. They were dressed as trolley dollies, weren't they?
Oh, yeah.
Anyway.
Sorry.
Hannah's bored with my story, so she's telling me to get on.
Oh, well.
It's because she doesn't, you know.
Lovely. So I'm just using the point of the iron just to press this seam open.
Right.
And you'll see why that's important in a little bit. I'm trying to feel underneath, being careful not to iron my fingers. just to make sure that obviously is folded back the other way.
Yeah.
So to be honest, at this point, it would be worth giving the whole cushion an iron because obviously you've been folding it backwards and forwards
exactly.
and faffing about with it. So this is not too bad. There we go. Presses beautifully. There we are. So that's nice and pressed open. Now I'm going to take my zip. I am going to pull it down a little bit.
Right.
I'm just going to pop a pin in the top to hold these two bits together.
Why is that? Because it's not going to run off that end, is
no,
it?
No, 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 it's not going to run off that end. It's just, obviously, I want to make sure that when I sew it round that those two are not flapping off
okay.
me.
Or a different
yeah, absolutely.
Angles.
And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn my zip over. So at the moment, I've got my zipper runner, which is this bit here,
yeah,
facing upwards. What I want is I want it to face downwards.
Right.
Into the fabric. There we go. So I'm lying it carefully along that open seam. And what we should be trying to do is we should be trying to line the zipper teeth that you can feel up with this line here.
With the seam.
With the seam,
That's the tacking seam.
Yes.
Yes.
And then I'm going to take my pins.
I've sussed it now.
Have you sussed it? Yeah. You worked out what's happening. And I'm going to pin through. This is going to be lumpy, but there's not much we can do about this because we've got no edge to pin over.
Yes.
Clip over, sorry, with the clips. So just going to pin. I have realised watching myself, I do pin at a funny angle.
Do you?
Yeah, I kind of don't pin straight. I kind of sometimes end up pinning really wonky.
Have you noticed you do it at home or are you just doing it on telly?
Just on telly.
Oh.
At home, I'm perfectly... I think it's because I do it at this angle on telly.
I bet you're doing it because you're thinking that
whereas
it's there.
Whereas at home, I'm, like, moving stuff
yes,
around
exactly.
and obviously walking around the table and all sorts. So
playing your video games.
Yeah, well, not me. Husband, I'm sewing.
Pandalicious Pandalings Pod Canvas. This is the canvas fabric from Art Gallery. Beautiful, isn't it? £8.95 for 50 centimetres. Lovely quality, beautiful quality. Okay.
All righty. So that's all in place. I'm just going to pop.
Oh, so what foot are you putting on then?
I'm putting on a zip foot.
Of course, because you're putting
in
a zip.
If I can find where I've put my zip foot, I might have to get Jay to get me it.
Oh, no.
Again.
Is Jay on standby?
Can't find the zip foot.
What we might do, if we have not got it, right? What? Well, we get you a zip foot. We won't go any further.
No,
we won't go any further.
I'll
go and take you across to see the fabrics. That's what we'll do. While Jay finds the zip foot for Sammy. So, the canvas fabric that we're using to make those cushions is this. Oh, did you find out a width for me, Hannah? Oh, I'll measure it for you in a second. Oh, Jake, you get me a tape measure as well when you've done that. Thank you. This is the canvas fabric that we are using to make said cushions. Do you know what? This would be lovely. You know, we were talking the other day about library book bags and things, you know, library books, school book bags and things like that, like a drawstring bag. This would be lovely because it's very, very sturdy as well as being quite smart. And if they're all lined up at school on the hooks and everything, you're going to see yours first, aren't you? Pandalicious Pandalings Pod Canvas Fabric. The only one of the ones we're showing you today that's the canvas finish, the canvas fabric, £8.95 for half a metre. It's a lovely, lovely quality. As Sammy said, it's soft and squidgy, but it's very, very durable. I'll measure the width of that for you in a second because we go then on to the marine solid, which is the one that Sammy's used as her piping on her cushion. Really, really lovely colour, isn't it? Like a petrol-y blue almost. £3.25. Now, this is from our Spectrum Solid fabric by Macauer. £3.25 for half a metre. Really lovely. It looks gorgeous against, well, I can see it there, against the black and the white. But also for you to use any of the other fabrics that we've got on display today. Goes beautifully with all of those. Okay, then we've got the other patterned fabrics. I've got to take them all out. Sorry. Right, this is Hannah's favourite. While you're looking at this, I'll get Jay to pick up that one for you. There you go. Oh, hang on, we're not going to see him. There we go. Pandalicious Panda Garden Recess, this one. £7.95. Oh! This isn't as heavy. This isn't as heavy as the canvas. This is a love... Oh! It's all going swimmingly well today, isn't it? £7.95 for half a metre. Really, really, really gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Beautiful, isn't it? And then let me move that one to one side. So then I've got, oh, the one that you just saw, this one here, this is cute. This is Sammy's favourite. This is the cotton bud one with the hiding pandas on it. Beautiful. What a lovely collection, isn't it? £7.95. Pandalicious Hidden Panda Cotton Bud by Art Gallery. Good quality, fabulous cottons there. £7.95 for half a metre. Fold that one up. Then there's this beautiful one here. Really, really gorgeous print, this one. This one is called Nap Time. They're all having little naps. It's really, I love the colours of this one. Really gorgeous petroly blues. Really, really beautiful, beautiful colours in there. This is the Nap Time. £7.95 for half metre. We love this one. We love, love, love this one. Look gorgeous in a shirt. That one. Is Chrissy watching today? I wonder if she is. She's going to make me a shirt out of this. Okay, let me move that one along. Then I've got the other... panda print, but this is in the cotton. This is in the cotton fabric, not the... It's a lighter weight. Well, I say it's lighter weight. It's a lovely shirt weight of fabric. It's like a shirt fabric. Lovely quality, gorgeous quality. Again, it's the same Pandalicious pandalines. £7.95 for half a metre. Really, really lovely, isn't it? Then I've got my solid colours, which I'll just go through quickly because Sammy's all ready for me. Okay. So we've got aqua and charcoal here on the stand. Aqua and charcoal. Actually, while you're looking at those, I'm just going to get the tape measure and measure the width of the canvassy fabrics. They're Macaua. They're from our Spectrum range. Really, really, really lovely Spectrum range. That's the aqua you can see on one side. And we've got charcoal going across the bottom there. Oh, thank you. Lots of people buy these in general. Right, just so you know, it's... 58 inches across. So it's a 60-inch, the canvas one is like a... Well, you know when you buy furnishing fabrics, that's like a 60-inch across, that one. Okay, and then the other two solids I've got are grass and black. Oh, they look nice together, don't they? They look quite very stark, don't they? You've got the grass and the black there. I think we need to get these edges overlocked, don't we? Let's get that one fraying away there. Really, really lovely colours. Now, the thing is, if we haven't got a colour that you like today in the Spectrum Solid, go to the website. We've got so many, and it's good quality, £3.25. Lots of people buying that, just having their stash the whole time. So there's the black one on the side and the green one at the bottom there. But if you ring the call centre, they'll be able to help you with that. Right, I've got to get back to Sammy now because... Yes, I heard you the first time, thank you. Getting instructions from my producer, Hannah. Right, let's carry on with the zip then. Sure. Before I do anything with that fabric, let's carry on.
So I haven't done anything, I've just changed my zip. I've just put the zip foot on the machine, okay. That's fine. So I'm going to pop this in the machine now.
Right.
Again, being careful that I want to make sure that that is all on the same side.
Yes.
Because it's going to get caught in the stitching anyway, but we want it to get caught neatly as opposed to...
Yes.
Not neatly.
Puckered. You don't want it puckered.
Oh, no. Nobody likes that. So I've moved my needle across slightly.
Yes.
And I've put my zipper foot on. And I've got the majority of the fabric on the far side of the machine.
Yes.
Rather than having to wrap it underneath there. I'm going to start at this end because I want to come back to the end where we have cut the zip.
Yes.
And I want to do a lot of stitching at the bottom there to make it really secure. Yes. So I'm starting at this end. I'm going to wind my needle down in so that I know exactly where I'm stitching. I'm just going to move my foot pedal. And I'm just going to carefully... You can see I'm not going... actually right up against the teeth because obviously we're going to have fabric in the way.
Yes.
And if we get too close, it's going to catch when we try and undo it. So I'm putting the zip teeth to the edge of the zip foot as opposed to putting it under the zip foot, which you can do if you need to. Well, I'm just going to take my pins out with my pin cushion. There we are. Move that out of the way. There we go. So I'm just going to go gently. I'm not going to whiz this through because I want to make sure that I keep it... I mean, the pins are keeping it in place, but I want to be able to manipulate it myself if I need to whilst we're going along. So I'm going to stitch to the zip, stitch the pin, remove the pin, move down. I do find a lot of people don't realise that you can... A bit like when you're driving a car, the foot pedal, you want... It's something to get used to, you know, foot pedal control. Obviously, this has a nifty little button up here that says you can go really slow, which will set it going really slow.
Yes.
Or you can set it to the top where you can go really fast. But you don't have to go really fast. No one's going to tell you off for chomping through really slowly.
Yes.
It's, you know, to gain your confidence. So.
Now, this would be the bit where I'd be a bit...
Yeah.
Yeah, go on.
So what I do here is I've stopped. I've come to where my zipper runner is, yeah. Which means it's going to get in the way a little bit. So I'm going to wheel my... Sorry, my arm keeps getting in the way. I'm going to wheel my needle down into my fabric.
Yeah.
And I'm going to lift my foot.
Right.
And then I'm going to reach in underneath and pull it out of the way.
Oh, it's simple.
There we go. And I'm going to put my foot back down so I don't forget, because that's embarrassing if that happens.
All these years that I've put zips in, and that's never occurred to me to do that.
Yeah. There we go. And then I've just separated these out so I can make sure that I'm really on that line. And then I'm going to carry on. There we go. Just going to go to the end. There we are. And then again, I'm going to needle down, foot up, twist. And then I'm going to replace the other side of the zipper back in place and make sure I'm lining it up well. And then
Mary
I'm going
Kate
to do this bit by hand.
So this is a brilliant zip putting in demonstration. Thank you, Sammy.
Thanks very much.
She's going to have a go at doing it.
I must admit, I do love teaching people about zips because lots of people are really scared of them. And they really aren't, they shouldn't be, well, they shouldn't be scary. I know they are because obviously, you know, you see that it's a feature and you're going to see it and everything like that. But it doesn't have to be. Shouldn't be that scary. Right, I'm going to put my foot back down and then carry on stitching back down the other side. There we go. And again, when I reach the zipper at this end, it's going to be a bit more tricky. Oh, see?
Oh, yeah.
Didn't put my needle down. No. There we go. I'm going to slide it up. I might have to lift my foot up a little bit more just to get that through, but you should be able to push it. There we go.
There you go.
That's why we didn't put it too close to the edge. I zipped it quite far down so that we had room to push it back the other way again.
Yeah.
All right, and then I'm going to carry on. There we go. Just going to go back a... No, backwards. Backwards. There we go. So, I'm going to wheel down in, lift up my foot. And this is the bottom of the zip where we need it to be really secure. So I'm going to go over it a few times. Forward.
Yes, now this is the bit important bit, isn't it, to secure? Because this is where we've chopped
backwards.
The zip off.
Absolutely. There we go. So I've gone
so
over it a few times.
The needle doesn't mind that... Because it's not a metal zip. You can just run backwards and forwards.
Nylon
over.
Coil is different. Basically, the way that zips are made is obviously it's... Lots of people think they're lots of little individual teeth, which on the bigger, chunky zips, they are.
And but on the metal zips, I'm
yes, they are, yes. But with a nylon coil, you can stitch through because it is literally just a coil of nylon that is attached in a very special way to the fabric strip.
So it's not a solid piece of plastic.
So it's not solid. It's really
like
soft and pliable, which is why they're so amazing.
OK, now let's do the reveal on this zip, then.
So then we turn it over and admire our not very straight stitching. Sorry about that.
But you see, what you could do is you could do that that stitching with the same colour. Your bobbing could have been the blue.
I use white when I'm on screen, obviously, because it means that you can see it. But yes, basically you're going to stitch. And if you were doing it in the same colour, it wouldn't show so much. But it's not quite so straight. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in with my quick unpick. And I'm going to unpick the tacking stitch.
Right, it's important to make sure you get the tacking stitch and not another line of stitching in there.
But you shouldn't have any other lines of stitching anywhere near
okay,
it.
Okay,
so.
Perfect. So if you have,
so, and obviously
wrong.
You can use the nylon coil to press up against to make sure you're doing it in the right place.
And that's why it's called the seam ripper.
And we're just going to obviously slide very carefully. I've caught, that's where my zip runner is. Not right to the end.
Yeah.
Turn it round and go from the other end in like you would with the buttonhole.
Yeah, so you,
so
don't...
That you don't go off the end. There we go. And then your zip is in. That's it.
Wow.
And then obviously you need to go along and pick out all these little bits of thread. I do that with a rubber, like a pencil rubber. There you go.
Fantastic.
And then your zip's in and everything's stitched and it's all in place.
And then how do you finish the other
three?
So
you make sure that you leave this open, obviously, because we're going to turn it through.
Yes.
So we then go around to do the other sides. And then we just straight stitch them in
place. Oh, yes, because you're using your zippers, you're like you're bagging out hole, really, then. How fantastic.
So then again, at the corners, we just want to make sure they're all facing the same direction. All your, you know, your binding pieces, sorry, all your binding pieces need to be facing the same direction. So just make sure they're all kind of facing the same way. Line that up, and then you're just going to straight stitch, clip them with the Wonder Clips. Let's see if we've got... Yeah, we've probably got time to do it.
We've got plenty of time, yeah.
I was worried I was running out of time. It's unusual, I'm not running out of time. There we go. Thank you.
Wonder Clips, £7.95 for 10 of them.
Invaluable. Love them. Okay. Just going to move that to the other end.
You've got the others down there. That's why I couldn't pass you.
Oh,
anymore.
There we go. Hoarding them. There we go.
Okay, while you stitch that, this fabric is the beautiful, beautiful, beautiful canvas. Now, it's Pandalicious. Pandaling's Pod. It's the monochrome. Never goes out of fashion, does it? Looks really, really stylish. But it is a canvas fabric that 60 inches wide. And it's got a lovely, lovely, lovely... It's not like a heavy canvas, but it's durable, but it's also very, very soft. We've made the two triangular cushions out of there. And then the marine is the blue spectrum. Solid by Macawa, running down each of those seams. We haven't put piping in it, so we've kept it lovely and soft in the seams there.
It's a bit bulky at the corners, but that's okay.
Now, you've used the canvas fabric to make the cushion with, but could you use these? I've brought these two over with me. Could you use these as well?
You absolutely can, yes. I think they're beautiful fabrics, and there's no reason why you can't.
Would you put interfacing on the back of them? Would you put an iron on interfacing if you're making a certain cushion?
I would if you're making
like
something large, only because obviously these are beautifully soft, which is great, but obviously it does mean that they're not going to be so hard wearing for homeware fabrics. Particularly things that are going to be sat on a lot, do you know what I mean? And if you've got it in a kitchen, you know, jeans and things are going to rub against it. So interfacing is a good thing to make it stiff. Also, because we're making something that's three-dimensional, obviously this canvas is slightly stiffer, and I would worry with this that it might not hold the point.
Oh, yes, it might cave in, you know, at the top. But it doesn't matter, because it's still a squidgy... Oh, imagine yours bounces back. But nice squidgy thing there. That's the interfacing if you want to buy a metre square at £2.95. Look at these. Look at these. Well, you're still stitching, aren't you?
I am, sorry. Can
look at these. These are fabulous fabrics, these.
I like these because... Oh, I'm distracting. It's almost got that triangular shape within the
there. And the little family there having a little nap. Pandalicious Panda Garden Naptime Fabric by Art Gallery. You know that Art Gallery. Contemporary, chic and luxury. £7.95 for half a metre. So if you've got a metre of that, that would make a lovely big cushion, wouldn't it? Really, really lovely, that one. So that one is the Naptime. And then the one underneath, this is nice. Oh, now Ginger Mike's coming up with all different... Oh, well, I'd put a triangle of that with a triangle of that with a bit of that with a bit of binding of that one. This is nice, isn't it? Look, beautiful. It's fresh. This is a lovely, fresh one. This is the recess, meaning break time. £7.95 for 50 centimetres. That's such a beautiful fabric. Lots of suggestions of what you could make with it, like shirts and cushion covers. And what was the other one, Hannah, did you just say? Oh, she's just looking it up now. Oh, blinds, that's right.
Oh, yeah, lovely.
They'd make lovely blinds, wouldn't they, for a conservatory?
Particularly again, because it's got that slightly bigger print.
Yes. Yeah, really, really gorgeous. So that's £7.95 for 50 centimetres. The cut fabric, when you buy the cut fabric, it comes in the most gorgeous little box, wrapped in tissue paper and everything like that. Really stunning. Because when you buy cut fabric, you don't want it just crammed in a carrier bag like you get in some shops. Hannah and I went shopping before we launched the channel, and we went to this one shop, and it just got scrunched into a carrier bag like that. That was way too small for the amount of fabric that we'd bought. Now, the Wonder Clips, really gorgeous Wonder Clips, £7.95 for 10 of them. So you're just going round the other two sides of the bottom triangle now, aren't you?
Yes, and actually I'm just sealing up as well at the same time the the end where the zip is.
Yeah.
Because obviously we didn't sew all the way to the edges. Oh, yes, of course. But I don't have to go far, and I just have to sew up to the edge of the tacking.
What did you pad it with?
I just used stuffing, just our regular toy stuffing.
Oh, you used the toy stuffing? Oh, I've got that here.
Because it's
you might have already got some of this from Joe's show. There you go. What'd you get there? 200. Now, that will go a long way, won't it?
Yes, yes. It would do two of the small ones or the larger one.
250 grams for £2.95. Now, remember, if you've missed out on anything, you can watch us on YouTube. You can watch all these shows on YouTube, and you can pause them on YouTube. So there's a little bit, if you're making it along with Sammy or Joe, you can pause it with them. Somebody wants to see your rose gold scissors. Oh, we'll just show those.
Oh, wow.
Very quickly, I only got 1 minute left, so... you're done now. I was about to say you're back in an hour, but you're not, are you?
No, not this. Not
Joe's... now I don't want to say this. Joe's buying these for her mum for Mother's Day. I hope she's not still watching. They're lovely, aren't they? £16.95.
They're my favourite.
You've got them, I know. When are you in next, then?
Tomorrow.
Oh, well, I'll see you tomorrow. Yep. I'm not going to give away what the theme is tomorrow. Joe's coming up after the break, remember. We are doing simple softies. But for now, let's have a reveal of the... Fantastic. So there you've got the three isosceles triangles around the outside. And then the equilateral triangle, is that the right word? On the bottom there, with the hidden zip. Mm-hmm. And you can just stuff it full of, either get a cushion pad, a pillow or something like that. Or, of course, the toy stuffing that we just showed you. Don't go anywhere. Thanks ever so much. I'll see you tomorrow. Joe is coming up with Simple Softies straight after this break.
The Sewing Quarter is a new, inspirational sewing and quilting channel here to help educate our viewers with some of the best designers in the business. We hope to bring you some exciting demonstrations with some of the top industry experts. We're part of the Immediate Media family. Immediate Media is a fast-growing multi-platform company who operates some of the most loved brands across the UK. Our brands range from our first TV shopping channel adventure with Jewellery Maker to several successful magazines such as Simply Sewing, Radio Times, BBC Good Food and many more. We've been working incredibly hard to set up and bring you our new exciting channel, and we hope that we can help inspire you with new ideas and projects. Join us on Friday the 17th, where we'll be showcasing ideas for the very hungry caterpillar with guest designer Joe Carter. 8 a.m, how to make a baby changing bag. 10 a.m, create your very own baby cot quilt. Make sure you don't miss out.
Here at the Sewing Quarter, you'll hear us talking about pre-cuts a lot of the time. And I can hear you saying, what's a pre-cut, John? Now, pre-cuts, they're pieces of fabric that have been bundled together, all cut to the same size, usually from complementary fabrics, so you've got a lovely little bundle to take home and start your sewing. Pre-cuts come in all shapes and sizes, but here are a few of the most popular. This is a jelly roll. I love jelly rolls. Now, these are normally 40 strips of fabric. They are all 110 by 6.35 centimetres. To you and me, that's 44 inches by 2.5 inches wide. They're normally cut from 8 different fabrics, but look how gorgeous they are. Now, one word of warning. They look beautiful like this. When you cut them open, all the fabric spread everywhere. You'll never, ever be able to put them back together again. This is a charm pack. There are 42 pieces of fabric, 12.7 centimetres by 12.7 centimetres. So basically, it's a 5-inch square. You get so many gorgeous fabrics in a charm pack, you'll find an awful lot of patterns inside a charm pack as well. Another favourite pack is the Fat Quarter Pack. Now, these measure 55 centimetres by 50 centimetres, or like me, 22 inches by 20 inches. Now, you normally find lots of different fabrics all bundled together. They're all different colours, all different shapes, but you know what? Unlike the jelly rolls and unlike the charm packs, the number of pieces of fabric can alter from 2 to 30. Look! Whichever pre-cut you choose, you've just got to remember two things. One, all the fabrics will go so beautifully together. And two, someone else has done the boring, laborious task of cutting them all out. So it's all about getting on with the sewing, which is what we love here at the Sewing Quarter.
Don't forget, shopping with us is easy and simple. You can just contact us at 0800 112 4433 and speak to our UK-based call centre to place an order. Or shop online with us at www.sewingquarter.com.
Look, aren't they lovely? Now, if you saw these in a certain toy shop, how much would you expect to pay for these? They're gorgeous, and don't they look complicated on how to make them? Well, they're not at all. They're not at all. Joe's here to show us how to make simple softies. How am I going to get my hands? Well, I'm going to let you see the fabrics, first of all. Have you ever looked at these gorgeous fabrics? Go and look at the gorgeous fabrics in your own time. Got some gorgeous Tilda fabrics to show you. To the fabrics. Thank you. Cherry blossom, these three are called. These three are called cherry blossom. Now, what I love about these, and which you might not be able to see on your telly, is that the background is like a very, very fine gingham. Really, really like a fine gingham, the background is. Really lovely, aren't they? So now they come. Now, £7.95 for half a metre. This is the pink. It's just called pink. Cherry blossom. They're all called cherry blossom. This is the cherry blossom pink, though. It is gorgeous. It's got that vibrant green in the centre of the flower. Really lovely. Now, you know Tilda fabrics are good quality. You know Tilda fabrics are like the designer in the fabric world, aren't they? Oh, you can see there. You can see the gingham in the background there. That's really lovely. Now, it comes in half metre increments. Remember, £7.95 for half a metre. But you can buy it as many metres as you like, and they don't come in half metre pieces. Obviously, if you order 2 metres, which is 4 units, you get 2 metres of fabric. It's not cut up into 4 sections. What's next after the pink? Le bleu. It's blue. It's a lovely baby blue, this one. It's just called blue. Cherry blossom blue fabric from Bumblebee range. Again, £7.95. Now, that's lovely because it's the blue and the yellow. So you've got the blue gingham at the background and then you've got the yellow stamens, I think they're called, the middle of a flower. Isn't that right? Then moving on to the green. So the pink had green, the blue has got yellow, and then the green has got like an orangey colour in the centre of the flower. Really, really look at that. Isn't that lovely? Classic, gorgeous and beautiful. So the graphics will come in for that one in a sec. £7.95 for half a metre there. Really, really lovely fabric. So those three are three of the fabrics that... Oh, no, those are the fabrics that Joe has used today. They are from the Tilda Bumblebee range. From the Tilda Bumblebee range they are. Now, I've just got 3 solid fabrics here with it. Yes, just the 3 that Joe's used as well. Really lovely. Now, the Spectrum, the Macawort Spectrum fabric... we've got them on our website. There are so many colours to choose from. We've got them all out in the office. And they're bright, gorgeous, gorgeous colours. So we've got the white here. £3.25 for half a metre. It's really, really lovely, isn't it? Good quality, really. Oh, it's called optical white, that one. Optical white. I wonder why it's called optical white. Do you think it's because opticians wear coats made out of that colour? Bright white, isn't it? Oh, apparently the girl that eats soup every day, Laura. We've got this lovely girl in the office called Laura. She only eats soup, drinks soup. Nothing else, just soup. She blames her mum for getting it for her, but, you know. Anyway, that's the white, that's it, that's the white. Now, I better wait for the colours of these now, then, hadn't I? Vienna orange. That's gorgeous. That's a really, I'd call it Seville orange, you know, kind of that deep orange. Really lovely colour. Again, you might not want to make a teddy bear with them. You might just buy it for your stash. I'll just move out of shop there. And then we've also got this lovely blue. So what are they called, the blue, Hannah? Cornflower. That's perfect. That's a perfect description. Cornflower blue. Again, it's in the... Oh, it's in the Spectrum. It's in the Spectrum solid range there in cornflower blue. £3.25 for half a metre. Right, OK, I'm going over to see Joe. You've seen enough of me. Oh, I've just noticed they've got different tails. Oh, Joe. Which one are we going to make?
I was going to do the bear. Start with the bear. Okay. Talk about.
Shall I show the others first of all? Then. So Fox, we've got Mr. Fox. He's brilliant. Now we love him. Look at that. Then look at the tail. Oh, do you know what? Our sample table, in the other room, in the main office, we've got, like, a little area for where guests come and everything. And we've got all of the... everything that the designers and the experts have made on there, and it's, like, really tempting. It really is tempting to take something home. So then that was the fox. Then we've got the pussycat. In the Tilda fabric, in the cherry blossom green fabric. That's lovely, isn't it? And then we've got the... Oh, no, I've got two teddy bears here. There's the tail. Right, now, look at these two, right? Look at these two. Aren't they cute? Now, these are the same bear, aren't they?
They are. They're the same.
But with slightly different decorations on them. Look at their little tails! Sorry, I'm getting overexcited again. So this is the one we're making today?
It is, yes.
Are they not difficult?
No, this is... sort of pattern anyone could draw up
right
at home.
And you're going to show us how to do it now?
Yes. Well, this is the finished bear. I'm going to show the template, which actually works for all of the animals. The cat just has different ears and a different tail, but it's the same basic pattern. And the fox, I've added an extra piece in and done the head separately so that you can get the nice V for the fox's face.
But also, you could, if you want to, you could put stripes across their body, you know, cut that, and you could use that as your template and cut it and change it as many. So if you wanted one with a big stripe around its tummy or something, you could do that.
Absolutely. You could do anything. You could patchwork, do a piece of patchwork and then use this as your template to cut from the patchwork so you had a fully...
Okay, what I might do is take a picture of this... and have it put on our Facebook page so that if you want to see that, and we might put some write some measurements on it. If that, you're not in a rush, are you, when you leave?
I'm not.
You're not now. just put some measurements on. We'll take a picture and put it on our Facebook page so people can see it on their Facebook page. Right, OK.
So if you want to design your own, I always work from a sketch, a drawing, first of all, and I will do that on paper. Mark the centre line because you only need to work on one half of it.
Right.
And then use tracing paper to work out my template from the drawing. But as you can see with this one, this is the finished bear. So you need to add not only the seam allowance, but a little bit of extra for the, just for the shaping, really.
Yeah.
That will go around. So this template makes that bear. But to, because they're so simple, there are plenty of ways to sort of add detail. With this one, because this fabric's so beautiful, I picked out a few of the flowers and just embroidered around them.
A bit of embroidery. At what stage do you do that, then? Will you tell us what stage to do that as we're making it?
I will. That was before the back was put on. I just embellished the front and added the face and things then.
OK, right. OK, so if you start, and then a lot of you are asking about the fabrics. I'll get the fabrics in and bring them over here, but I'll just we'll just start the project.
OK, well...
Oh! You want... It's quilted.
It is quilted. It gives it a bit of extra depth. It makes it easy to stuff as well later on, and because there is some clipping for the corners, it just strengthens it as well. So you can go as complicated or as simple as you want with the quilting, just a slightly bigger piece of wadding. I don't bother with a lining.
I'm going to take you back a stage. So you've got this.
Yes.
And you cut that out of your Tilda fabric.
Yes.
Oh, exactly that size. No seam allowance or anything like that.
No, this includes the seam allowance. So I would just draw around that on the reverse of the fabric and then cut it out and then pop it onto...
Pop it onto a piece of wadding and then literally do whatever quilting you want on the top of there.
Yes.
Perfect.
And because these are turned through the back piece is half of the template.
But with a bit of seam allowance.
But with the quarter-inch seam allowance added all the way down.
Okay,
there.
So they've got a seam down their back. We need somewhere to put the tail in as well, wouldn't you? There. Okay, brilliant. So you've quilted one front and two backs.
One front and two backs, making sure that the backs are mirror images, and then just trim around to remove the excess wadding.
Right.
So I'll do that. But with a project like this, you can... In fact, this particular pattern appeared in Love Patchwork and Quilting and people sent me pictures of ones they'd made.
Oh.
And one was a little superhero. So he had an initial on his
They put little pants and a cape on it and things.
I think he did have a little cape, and it was adorable. So even if something's simple or relatively easy to make, you can add layers of complexity and details and really make it something special.
The scissors that Jo is using, you're loving them because they're rose gold. These are ones you're getting your mum for Mother's Day, aren't they? She wasn't watching, was she?
Well, I'm hoping she is not a big fan of surprises.
Well, you're getting these. What's her name?
Helen.
Helen, you're getting these. Oh, you saw me that before. Helen, you're getting these for these scissors for Mother's Day. And a card. You'll get a card as well. £16.95. They're very sharp and they're rose gold. They're beautiful, aren't they? Absolutely gorgeous.
Okay, so there's... done.
Okay, they're rose gold coloured, these. The little scissors are rose gold plated. These are rose gold coloured. So you don't get home thinking you're getting gold scissors.
The cat toy, I quilted more densely. It's got quite a fine crosshatch design on it. The cat. You make out it's quite a pale thread, so it might...
Oh, yeah, it did. Crosshatch. Crosshatch. Did you say that?
I did, and it's quite a densely quilted one.
But it doesn't take over. It doesn't take over the... You know what I mean? The quilting is lovely, but it doesn't take over the design, does it, at all?
No, it's quite subtle. With the bear, though, I went for slightly more obvious quilting.
Yes, on his tummy.
Jay said he looks like he's got abs.
Can you see him there? Lovely, isn't it? Oh, Kathleen says, this looks like a lovely little project. Kathleen, isn't it lovely? And one you could do, I suppose, with... If you've on the school holidays... If you're on the school holidays and you've got a project if you've got children staying at thing, you could supervise them making their own teddy bear, really, couldn't you?
Absolutely. Children love... My sons love making things.
Oh, do they? Yeah. Oh, they've got the genes, then?
Well, possibly, or they've just been indoctrinated.
Don't say that. They've got the genes.
Yes, the genes.
Right, this... Lots of you asking about this. Well, I'll let Jo cuts that last one out. This is from the Bumblebee range. This is the Tilda fabric we're using for this. It's lovely. You can buy it in the half metre increment. You can buy as much as you want, but it comes... The minimum amount is half metre, then you buy an increment of half metre from there. If you're buying on the web... I'll just lift it up for you. There you go. If you're buying on the web, one unit is half a metre. Now, on there, it just looks like a green fabric with lovely flowers on it, but actually, when you come in close, you will see that the background is a lovely, lovely, very, very tiny, tiny gingham there. £7.95 for half a metre. Lovely detailing on those flowers from Tilda, isn't there? That's what she's known for, isn't she? All her details. Right, I'll just fold that one up. Do you want to see the other colours while I'm here? I'll just very quickly show you the other colours, then we'll get back to Jo. This is lovely. I think this actually might be my favourite. The blue. It's very fresh, isn't it?
The blue and the yellow is beautiful.
Oh, I thought you went to biscuit then. I think it's all a bit peckish. I'll show you what Jo's doing in a second. This is the blue fabric, £7.95 for half a metre. Really, oh, you can see the gingham on that one as we pull away from that one. Really lovely, lovely fresh colour. Okay, and then last but not least, the pink. We'll start off with a nice big close-up so we can see the gingham on this one. Not that I'm directing from the floor. There we go. Now, that pink is a lovely pink, isn't it? A luscious pink. There you go. It's pink and green, lovely opposite each other on the colour wheel. Really, really blend nicely together. At £7.95. Now, you might have bought the charm pack from us and then you love this fabric. Now, you can buy it by the half metre. By the half metre, £7.95 half metre. Right, sorry, Jo, I didn't mean to interrupt you then. So, we'll carry on.
Something to bear in mind if you're quilting them, there will need to be clips made. Once the back and the front are sewn together, clips made at the internal corners.
Yes.
So I've stitched around here, but this is just to hold the wadding right up to the edge of the fabric, so they're not quilt lines as such. But you don't want your quilting
to be near your
to there corners. Because you don't want to clip through your quilt lines.
Of course, yes.
So something to bear in mind.
Okay.
Now, the bear has little curved ears, little rounded ears.
Oh, sorry, did I just take that? Sorry, I just grabbed that as a shot, sorry. But you see, now, you see, the thing is, we're doing the bear, which has got rounded ears, but the pussycat has got pointy ears. And you can see it better on the blue one, but the blue one's got quilted round ears. And then Mr. Fox has got top-stitched White is because Joe's done a... well, that's because that looks like you, you see. Director Mike likes this one best. Right, Sarah has asked, or was said... Oh, yeah. No, have you got an agent?
No.
Right, I'm your agent. We're doing a book. Who was it that said it? Sarah. Sarah suggested it, but I'll do it. A book of all your patterns. It would sell brilliantly. A book of all your, because she loves all of your toys, all your soft toys.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you. Anyway, carry on.
A bit embarrassed now.
Oh, don't be embarrassed.
Right, the ears. To give them a bit of depth and a bit of squidge.
Yeah, squidge.
I always have scraps of wadding about from.
That's a surprise.
Yes, and I save them all in a bag. So they're all ready to go. But if you sew the ears, so you have them right sides together, one on top of the other, but if you have them on top of some wadding as well and then sew round, they're pre-stuffed almost when you turn them out.
So, right, let's just do that again. So you're doing right sides together of the fabric, but putting it on the wadding underneath.
Yes.
Then you're going to bag out, but with the wadding attached
with
to it.
Wadding.
So the wadding's included, encased in the seam going round.
Yes, and then you can add some stitch lines and they just give a little bit of depth to the ear. So should I sew these together?
Yes, yes, please. And you can just stitch that on a normal foot and a normal with the wadding underneath and everything.
Yes, that's how I normally do it.
You're very into your curves today, aren't you?
I know. People are not always a huge fan of curves.
Yeah, but it's worth it.
It is. And if just do a couple of stitches and readjust it. Because they're only ever a few curves, so it's fine to just walk slowly through them, I think. Oh, see, I've not checked the machine here.
Oh, what's the matter? What's an issue?
I've done large stitches.
Jay.
It's me. I should have checked as soon as
no,
I got here.
No, that's what Jay's here for.
But imagine these are neater stitches and smaller, yes. Following the curve.
Yeah, we could do it on the second one.
Should I do another one?
Yeah.
Go on, I'll try and get this one right. So right sides together.
Hang on a second. So you put the two right sides together, put it on the wadding, and then you put a normal size stitch.
Normal size stitch around the curve.
Lots of you loving these scissors. Now, please leave one for Helen. Mind, you've got lots of other things we can choose for your mum if these do sell out. These are lovely, aren't they? Dressmaking shears, gold, rose gold coloured. Gold plated. Thank you. Yes, now, thank you, Director Mike. Why don't you just direct and me and Hannah will produce the show? They're rose gold plated. They are rose gold plated, not just gold coloured. They're rose gold plated. £16.95. Now, you can dial the number 0800 112 4433 or go on the web www.sewingquarter.com. Now, if you want to buy these while we're on the show, you need to go to the live page on the web because they'll have been taken off the web shop. That's all. Right, sorry, Joe.
Okay. So there we go. I've sewn around the curve.
Yes.
And now...
What size stitch have you used then? Just a normal...
I tend to do about 2.5 millimetre stitch.
Okay.
Trim away the excess. Batting, taking care not to catch the fabric. But then we will clip.
Oh, okay.
Now, around the curve.
Have you cut the wadding the same size? Sorry, have you cut the wadding the same size?
Yes.
Oh, just, yes, exactly.
By and large, yeah. It's the same. You don't want it any bigger, but a little bit smaller is fine. Yeah. I do love these scissors. There we go. And that just removes some of the bulk.
Yeah, of course. Brilliant. So just turn it through then.
Give the seam a little bit of a roll.
And can you iron wadding? If you wanted to iron that, could you be all right to iron?
You might lose some of the volume.
Oh, okay.
And I do only on a cool iron, but
yes.
Often things like this actually, it helps just to give it a little press.
Well, I was going to say, because the little curves, just to get the curves out and everything, yeah.
And you can quilt. these. I mean, you don't have to quilt them at all.
Oh, no, I like that. I like that. I like just a line of top stitching going around that one.
Should I do the same on this one?
Yeah,
then?
Go on then. We don't want odd ears, do we? But you could do a patchy bear, couldn't you? You could do different coloured ears, like you have on the sort of foxy one as well, if you wanted to. Because you know what I mean? Like, you could do the pink ears on the green body or something, and a pink tail, and things like that. Look lovely. You can mix and match. Because these fabrics are beautiful, aren't they? They are from the Bumblebee collection. They're from the Bumblebee collection. They are lovely. They're £7.95 for half a metre. I remember we sell our fabrics in half a metre increments. Right.
There we go. Just neaten up the bottom edge a little bit. Then two ears. And always, when I'm adding ears or anything else, I always baste them in.
Oh, OK.
First. So you know and you won't lose them either. So I'll put these on this. The ears will fit. It's always helpful to mark in the seam allowance, so you know how wide your ears could be.
Oh, yes.
So they'll fit in that space there. So I'll baste these on.
So basically, your pattern's got, your body's got seam allowance and your ears got seam allowance, so you can just match the two raw edges, can't
yes.
you?
Yes.
Yeah. Perfect.
Do that.
I like the quilting you've done. That's kind of wavy lines, isn't it, on that one? Now, and this Tilda fabric's nice to work with as well, isn't it?
It is. You really can tell the quality with it.
So you're just doing a tacking stitch across there to hold them in?
I am, within the seam allowance.
Yeah. So you won't be seen, yeah, exactly.
Yeah. It's probably my top toy sewing tip is basting everything in, just to make sure ears and tails and things, it's always helpful.
We don't want them to move, do you? When you're bagging out or whatever, if they move, then the whole thing's ruined. You know, or not ruined, you've got to start again, unpack and everything. Unpack, unpick and everything.
And often as well, I'll make the tail and put it to one side and forget about it, and then it ends up without a tail.
Oh, yes, nothing. Oh.
So at least if I baste them, I've kept them somewhere safe.
And so is it the tail next, then?
The tail is next. It's just a really simple arch.
What would you call it? Did you give it a name then?
Like
a shark's fin.
It is a bit like a shark's fin. It's always easier if there's a fold because there are fewer seams then, especially with something small. So that's the whole tail piece, and I quilted it on top of the batting, the wadding, the same as these. So I quilted that up, trimmed it down, and then just fold it over and stitch. And then that forms the tail.
But you can do like you have on all of yours, they've all got completely different shaped tails, haven't they? Do you know what I mean? So you could choose which tail you wanted, really.
You could, and they're all folded. They all have a top fold in them. So, actually, I have.
Are we seeing the tails? See, they've all got little. They've got the little shark's fin one that we're just making now. And then we've got the very long. So it's folded over and then slightly rounded at the ends, that one. Then we've got the lovely shark's fin one there, and then the two-coloured one with the angle on the fox. That's a lovely one, the fox's tail, isn't it? Really lovely.
So this is a fox's tail piece before it's been trimmed. So that's the shape, so it folds.
Can we just show that? So that's the fox's tail there. And then you trim it down and... Oh, I see. So when you bagged it out, it's got that kind of shape to it. Oh, that's fantastic. I love the quilting on that, because it's... really, well, it's like a fox's tail, isn't it?
Right, okay. I'll return to this one, but fold it over and then I'll sew along this curve.
Okay, brilliant.
We'll do that.
And that's why we've got the back, that we've got a centre back seam to put the tail in and to bag out, really, haven't we?
Yes, and, oh well, I won't rush ahead.
No, you've got plenty of time. I've got a little film to show in this hour, which will be in a few minutes' time. I think Hannah might be trying to talk to me, but I think she switched me off. Oh, I've got two messages. They'll be for you, Jo. Oh no!
Oh, is my mum watching?
Yes.
Well.
Oops. She says, I'm watching. The scissors are not a secret anymore. Oh. But it doesn't matter. Do you know what? It means you're getting a present you want, doesn't it, Helen? Anyway, Helen, lovely to meet you. Thank you for watching. She's gorgeous. I love your daughter. Anyway, and then who's the other one from? Oh, Kathleen, did you say? Kathleen, what a brilliant idea. Make them up and then stuff them with lavender.
That would be lovely.
Because my friend Dulcie makes lavender wax and sells them at the Morton in the Marsh show in September. But that would be a fantastic idea.
Would. Really,
really good idea. Oh, Kathleen, that's a nice idea. Thank you. So you can come to my... I've got so much lavender in my garden. Come and take as much as you want.
So the little tail, I'll just trim the seam allowance.
Oh, have fun at your mum's, wouldn't she? Right, she would anyway, wouldn't she?
She would.
Yeah.
I was hoping she might be at work, but she'd watch it. Oh. She'd watch it on...
Well, she's obviously not watching it on YouTube. She's watching live. No. She's not gone to work, then, do you think?
Well, she...
Don't give anything away, no.
No, no. I'm sure she's not throwing a sickie.
Oh, you can't say that! We don't condone throwing sickies here at Sammy Quarter.
Is the...
What do you need? The dobber? Yeah. Oh, now it was here earlier. No, I haven't got it back. There it is.
Oh, it's me.
Pauline, hello, my love.
There we go.
Right, she's going to make... She'd love to make one of these for her grandchild that's due in June. Oh, yes, we'll definitely write some measurements on there for you, and we'll take a picture and try and put it on Facebook for you, so you can sort of trace... I don't know how you do it, but we'll try it anyway. We'll try it. So, sorry.
So, I've marked on here... Yes. I want where I would like the tail to be, so starting just around the bottom of the arm.
Yes.
So I've put a mark on, and I've transferred that mark onto...
Yeah, OK. Well, no, we're doing this one, aren't we? So, the top of the tail sort of matches with the bottom of the arm. See what I mean? A line across the body there sort of matches with the arm. Perfect. We'll turn him over. Sorry. Oops. Oh, come on, John. One job. So how do now we attach it, then?
And I'll baste that in place. Now, you could baste it in place and then think, oh, I don't like the position of it. So just whip out the basting stitches and readjust.
You could put it in either way, couldn't you?
You really could.
That's a funny tail, that one. That's like a Manx tail. It's no, they haven't got a tail, but you know what I mean. But you could do whatever shape you wanted, really, couldn't you?
You could.
To add to the character of it.
I mean, you could even do like a little pom-pom tail and add it at the end.
Imagine that would make it a rabbit, wouldn't it?
It would, but you could turn it into a rabbit.
Oh, yeah. But what ears would you do for a rabbit? You have to do longer ears
long,
for a rabbit,
yeah, long and pointy,
and if made into a hare, even bigger ears.
Right, base that on. No, I think it'd work really nicely as a
rabbit.
Yeah,
so do I. There's a big hare, like a big wild hare lives in the lane. You have to drive down a little lane to get to my village. And he just sits and watches the traffic go past. But he's massive like this. He sits, I thought it was a Labrador. First time I saw him, I thought it was a Labrador. And then he jumped, but he sits like that. Just watching the cars go past like that. It's frightening. Anyway, before you go any further, have we got a little film to show? Which one is it, please? How to buy. Don't go anywhere. Little film, and I'll be back straight. We'll be back straight after this.
There are many different ways you can buy from us here at the Sewing Quarter. You can order from us by calling our free phone number at 0800 112 4433 and talk to the team at our UK-based call centre. Alternatively, there are other ways you can buy from us. You can go online and shop through our website at www.sewingquarter.com. You can even watch the show there and shop as you go. You can check out as many times as you like throughout the day and only pay a small fee of £2.95 postage and packaging for the whole day. We also offer a 30-day money-back guarantee on all products excluding custom-cut fabric. Our friendly UK-based team will help guide you through every step.
Hello, welcome back. In the last hour here, we've only got like half an hour to go. It flies by, doesn't it? My friend Jenny, who works with Meryl Streep, she said that she sits and watches it, right, and can't go to work. She can't go to work because she's just completely transfixed. When both Natasha and I are on, she loves it. Lots of you want to see the fabrics again, so we'll do a quick recap. And also, I've not even talked about the books yet, have I? I'll talk about those in a second. So, Jo, do you just have 5 minutes? Have a strawberry. There's some strawberries under there. Blue Tilda with the yellow flower. Gorgeous. £7.95. £7.95 for the half metre. Really, really lovely, isn't it? Cherry blossom, blue fabric, £7.95. Remember, we sell in half metre increments. That is just stunning. Love that blue and yellow. Moving on to the one we've been using to make the teddy bear with, which is the green... Oh, it's called teal. It's called teal, sorry. Teal, it's called. Wow. I'd have called it a spring green myself, but it's called teal. But just speak to the call centre. I'll say it's just say you want the green one. Teal fabric, £7.95 for half a metre, remember. Lovely. I love that. It's got the orange in the flowers there. Dropping down, look at the pink. The pink is just gorgeous, isn't it? Really, really lovely, rich. Excuse me, rich pink. Remember, it is the Bumblebee collection from Tilda. You know Tilda fabrics. You know the quality. You know the designs are gorgeous. This is Cherry Blossom, pink fabric from the Bumblebee range, £7.95 for half a metre. Do you know what? You could get a bit of each of them, and they'd all work so beautifully together, really, really nicely together. £7.95 for half a metre. Remember, we sell in half metre increments. Okay, we're not doing these. Okay. Okay. So, now I've got these three books. I've got these three books to show you here. These are Tilda books. This is the crafting springtime gifts. Now, this, again, would make a lovely, lovely gift, wouldn't it? Take into account that she'll have used Tilda fabrics to make all of these, because this is by Tone from Tilda. Really, really lovely ideas, isn't it? That's a gorgeous one. That one is called Crafting Springtime Gifts Book. So if you want to make a gift or you want to give the book as a gift, £7.95. That's a really, really, really gorgeous book. I'll give you another flick through because there's lots of little animals in there. Very nice. Obviously, Jo's showing us how to make her... Oh, look at those two. She's making her design, but this has got other ideas that you could use the Tilda fabrics with. Okay, so there's that one. Then I've just got to turn around from you. Then I've got Tilda summer ideas. This is lovely because this has got the ginghams and things like that. Really, really cute little book, this one. Tilda's summer ideas there. And I'll just... Now, if you've got our mini iron with the... you can make the legs with the slimline tip, isn't it, you put on. Anyway, £6.95, this book. Again, full of ideas. Aren't they cute? If watching Joe make these teddy bears has inspired you to make other... Oh, that's nice. It's got bags in this one as well. Oh, look, they're nice. No bunny rabbits still. No bunny rabbits yet. Really, really, really lovely. Oh, they're nice. Oh, look. Beautiful ideas. Oh, and there's all the patterns at the back. All the patterns at the back. And they're using all the Tilda fabrics like the cherry blossom here. And then... Last but not least, oh, now we had this morning in the first show. It was very, very, very popular. It's called Tilda's Studio. That's now that could be a coffee table book, that one, couldn't it? Again, look at the beautiful photography, beautiful Tilda fabrics, all the tips of how to make and everything. Oh, look, is that flat? Oh, now Hannah. That'd be nice. Hannah's got big hair, you see. That'd be nice in Hannah's hair, that, wouldn't it? When's your birthday, Hannah? Oh, I might make that for her birthday. Anyway, look, all these different... I'll get Joe to make it, actually. All these beautiful, beautiful, beautiful pieces to make. That is a lot, £14.95. That's called Tilda's Studio by Tone Finanga. Tone is the person who set up Tilda, who is the inspiration behind Tilda. So you know the fabric's good quality, you know the book's good quality too. OK, do you want me to talk about these... I've got the plain fabrics here, the solid fabrics here, because we've got the... The little fox made out of the orange down there. But we'll start with the white, will we? It's called optical white. I'll get my tummy out of shot there. It's the optical white. These are by Macauer. Now, you know the quality of these. These are £3.25 for half a metre. But you can have any metrage you want, as long as it's in half metre increments. So the minimum is 50 centimetres, and then on and on and on, you can have as much as you want, as long as we've got it in stock. But it all comes in one big piece, remember. It doesn't come in half metre pieces. That's optical white, £3.25 for half a metre. Moving on. Are you going to the blue, the cornflower blue, or you're going to... Now, was this called Viennese or something? Vienna, I knew I was nearly there. Vienna orange. Now, I don't know if Vienna's famous for its oranges, but Vienna orange, that's a really, really... It's like a brick, like one of those really rich brick orange colours. Now, it's lovely brick orange, really lovely colour. £3.25. And then you've got the cornflower. I can remember that one. Beautiful, beautiful cornflower there. And it is exactly what it says on the tin. It is cornflower blue, that one. At £3.20. It doesn't come in a tin, it comes in a box. Beautiful box. All the cut fabric comes in a beautiful box. At £3.25 for half a metre. Lots of people buying the solid fabrics just to have in their stash. Right, I'm going back now. I'm going back, so we've got to finish off our teddy bears. Remember, you've got about 20 minutes, if you've got any questions for Jo, 20 minutes to get in. We're making this one using the Tilda fabrics from Jo's own design. We'll put the pattern piece on Facebook later. That's the fabric there. That's the teal fabric there. £7.95, half metre. Oh, there's a pussycat as well, also made of the teal fabric. Teddy and pussycat. Really, really lovely, aren't they? Now, that one's got a lovely long tail there. But how much fabric would you say would make one of these? You'd need half a metre, and you could make a couple, couldn't you?
You could easily with half a metre.
Right. Yes. From half a metre, you could make a couple of these. OK, let's move on then. So what stage are we on now? So we've got the body. You just stitched the tail in place.
Just to keep it together. And at this point, you can embellish the front body however you want. So you could maybe do a bit of embroidery or details.
You've got different... I'll just show the different ones here. So you've got the face on here, which we're going to show you now, but you've got quilting on the tummy of that one. And then you've got straight quilting, which is straight quilting there, but you've got the face on this one, the lovely foxy face there. So what have you made your face out of? Because we're doing this one, aren't we? What have you made your face out of?
This is just a little piece of felt.
I think we've got that, haven't we?
We have. We've got some...
Oh, you get lots. Make lots of this. This is how it comes. Right, let me put the teddy bear down. This is how it comes here. Wool felt squares, or felt wool squares. Now, this is, the colour is known as honeysuckle. Honeysuckle. Now, you're going to make a lot of... You can make a lot of faces out of that. As a toy maker, what else would you use felt for? Because, as I say, there's a lot there, isn't there?
There is. I sometimes, making small toys, I will make them entirely out of felt.
Oh, OK.
But great for faces. Sometimes small birds are good for wings or tails and things like that.
Would you make the inside of a rabbit's ear, maybe, with felt?
You could do. It'd be nice to add a little piece of felt there, maybe stitch that on for a bit of...
Or paws.
Oh, paw pads are
You can
lovely.
Make little paw pads out of it, because it's endless, really, isn't it?
It is.
And the good thing about felt is it doesn't fray, does it? You can just cut it and use it.
It is. I have a box of all assorted colours of felt in my
There's
studio.
A surprise. Yes. Your poor husband, that's all I can say.
There is room for him.
Oh, good.
Almost.
So, how have you worked out the... Because your face looks like a teddy bear's head, the profile
it does.
Of it, doesn't it?
I just want a little sort of snout area and then the bits of the eyes. It just means it makes embroidering the face on a little bit easier because you have the area within to embroider into. So I've positioned that with the ears down, just below the ears and above what would be the neckline.
OK, right.
And because it's felt, actually, friction-wise, it just holds itself in place on there. So I would just... It's too difficult to machine sew around the little eyes. So actually, the embroidery holds the eye section
in place.
Oh, yes,
of course. That's going to hold them in
place. But I'm just going to sew around that area.
Another circle.
But you could do that by hand. I mean, blanket stitch would be really nice around there,
yes.
Or a running stitch,
yes.
Or anything like that.
But you're going to machine it.
I'm going to machine it.
In a circle.
People won't like me, will they?
No, of course.
Can
they not like you? Remember, the felt you're seeing there is £8.95 for 10 sheets, but the gorgeous teal fabric from the Bumblebee range, £7. I just went very quiet there because I was busy watching the stitching. I didn't want to disturb the stitching.
There we go. I've been a little bit speedy. And then, as before, with the owl, I'm going to stitch a circle. It's quite handy to mark it on. I've got the pen.
Got the pen there.
Mark a nose on.
Is this your signature face?
It is.
Not yours, I mean the teddy bears. We'll get letters about that now.
You're doing a little W mouth. It just means you can do one stitch for each, but I like to draw it out first because often they don't match. You end up with one side of the mouth.
Or it might not be in the same, it might not be even, everything. This pen, by the way, that Joe's used here is the washable. You can just it wipes off with a damp cloth the ink. So it's all right to wipe off on felt, is it, as well?
Yes, I've always used it on felt and not had a problem. I'll do the nose. I'll demonstrate the nose.
So you're just doing the nose with big stitches, then?
Yes, I'd like to do the border so I know the area.
Oh, you do the border again. So, sorry, yes, I see now.
I mean, you could just do big stitches all the way along.
But also, if it's a toy, it's going to get tugged at a lot, isn't it? So you want it to also be secure. If you just did one big stitch and one big stitch, something that they could catch, really, isn't it?
It could be pulled loose.
And, yeah.
Do that.
Oh, lots of interest in the books. I will be going through the books again in a second for you. Also, the Tilda fabric, you're seeing the teal. Oh, it's gone, the teal fabric here. The graphic was going across the bottom of the screen a second ago, but you've got the teal fabric here. Also comes in the green. No, it comes in the pink and the blue. Right, that's the teal one that we're actually using here, that Joe's actually using here.
I'm just doing some...
Oh, now someone else has messaged and said they're making one for a grandchild. Very popular, this little teddy bear. I wonder what animals they're going to go for, whether they'll stick with teddy bears or whether they'll do the fox or the pussycat. Michael upstairs loves the fox, really loves the fox. And Timothy likes the fox as well. I wonder what the fox is called, Foxy.
Okay.
I'm showing it. What noise does it make? You said, what animal does it make? And I was like, I don't know what you mean. Isn't it lovely? That's the fox there, which Joe's just adapted the head and the tail for that one. It's cute, isn't it? That's using the Vienna orange. The Vienna orange fabric there and the optical white. That orange is very vibrant, isn't it? Oh, do you know what? Oh, that would look lovely together. Those two oranges would look lovely together as well. There's the... we've gone off it. There's the graphics for the Vienna orange there. £3.25 for half a metre. Do you want to have another look at it? There you go. And the optical white is from the same range. That's also £3.25 for half a metre as well. Really lovely. OK, so... whizzing along there.
OK. I did this one in one stitch, but it's that bit too long. And you could do them if the mouth is a bit smaller, but the other ones I've done with two stitches. Yeah. I think that works a little bit better.
Would you not do... Oh, no, it's a teddy bear. Did you do whiskers on the cat? Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, so you can make it as you want, because the pussycat here has got the whiskers on it as well. So you could just do whatever you want, couldn't you, really? Do foxes not have whiskers? I don't know. I've never close to... Has a fox got whiskers? How do they know if they can get through the holes or not? Anyway.
Shall I give it an eye?
You tell me, Hannah, when you want me to do anything. Spectrum Solid in Macro Vienna Orange, that's this one.
It looks really nice against the white.
Doesn't it? It looks fantastic against the white. That one is cute. But you can make any animal you want, really. Just maybe make a teddy bear to start with, then let your imagination run wild. They're cute, aren't they? Really lovely. Giraffe. Could you have done a giraffe?
Maybe not from this template.
Oh, no, not from this one, Timothy, no. Timothy wants to make a giraffe.
It might need a slight alteration.
Yes, the neck might be a bit short. Have you done a giraffe? My friend Cherry adores giraffes.
I made one years ago. I've not made a giraffe in a long while.
OK, so that's a giraffe and... what was the other one we said earlier? Rabbit.
Rabbit.
Giraffe and rabbit.
Did we say magpie earlier?
Oh, no, magpie as well. Yeah, I forgot about the magpie already, see? That's how fickle I am, see? Right, let's do in the eye. Just going round the circle, round the outside eye, and then you'll fill the eye in. Okay, now, a lot of you are asking about... Do you want to just see the still or do you want me to go and get it? Right, a lot of you are asking about the Tilda Studio book, which is this one. We saw it in the first show, and it's there again now. Really, really beautiful book, like a coffee table book, that one, isn't it? Lots and lots of you asking about that and coming in for that. It's a really beautiful piece. It's the Tilda Studio book by Tone Finanga, £14.95. It is so beautiful, isn't it? A really, really lovely book. And I'll show you, before the end of the show, I will show you through it again, because I'll show you all three of the books, because you're loving all the books. Really lovely. It's like a lifestyle, isn't it? Tilda lifestyle book there. Really, really lovely.
And Tilda do lovely toy projects as well.
Do they?
Is there a bunny on one of those? Yeah, the bunny in the plant pots.
Oh, yes, the bunny's in the plant pots on the springtime one. Springtime, yeah. It's definitely springtime because yesterday, chucking it down with rain, freezing cold, and all the baby lambs arrived in the... behind my house is a farm, and all the baby lambs arrived in the field yesterday, and I thought, what a day to put them all out there. The cherry blossom... The cherry blossom fabric is the one we're using here. This is the teal colour, which is the fresh green colour. And I'll take you over and show you the blue and the pink before the end of the show, definitely.
So I've back stitched a circle and then I'm just filling it in with...
Have you wiped all the moisturiser off your hand this time, then?
I have. I've not put moisturiser on, but again, I think it's the pressure.
Of being on live telly, yeah. Your mum's watching. It's even worse.
Now
you know
I know.
What? Millions of people could be watching you, but as soon as a friend texts in and goes, oh, I'm watching you, suddenly you're like, it's even more nerve-wracking, isn't it, really?
It is. There we go. Is it worth me doing both eyes, or...?
Oh, OK, right, now, I've got an issue from earlier, but where have they gone? Yeah, we had them on that one there a minute ago. Oh, I've got some here, yeah. Right, before you go any further, Joe, I just need to say something. In the show earlier, we used the duck scissors, the duck bill applique scissors. This was in the first show. We showed, right, there was an issue about people being able to put them in your basket. Sadly, for some reason, I don't know why, but you can't buy them on the web. They are available, but the only way you can buy these is by ringing the number 0800 112 44 33. A lot of people have gone through on the phone, but a lot of people saying they can't do it on the web. If you tried earlier to put them in your basket, you still can't do it on the web now, but if you want them, because we're very, very, very limited at £12.95, they're applique scissors. They're fantastic. Don't wait too long. Don't wait too long because I don't want you to miss out. £12.95. OK, that's right. No, I'll keep you updated as much as I can. Right.
How are we doing for time?
Oh, you've got plenty of time. 12 minutes.
Should I do the other eye?
Yeah.
Well, I'll give him two.
Oh, 10 minutes, not 12. 10 minutes.
Right.
I've got that. I've got two different clocks, one saying 13 and one saying 12. But, oh, no. Which book do they want to look at? Oh, yes, definitely. Let's have a quick look at those. Don't put the clock on the floor, you naughty boy. Is Jay coming in? Or am I... Okay. Come on, Jay. Time is money. We'll carry on watching Joe stitching until Jay brings them in. He thinks he's on his lunch break already, is he? Come on, quickly, bring those books in. All of them, yes. Books, meaning plural. Thank you, Jay. I love him, really. Right. Let me just move these out of the way. Lots of you want to see these books. So we're starting off with the crafting springtime gifts. Lovely Easter gift. When's Easter this year? £7.95. Do you know what? If you bought somebody an Easter egg, you could pay more than £7.95 and it's gone within a day, isn't it? This be on your shelf forever, this, wouldn't it? Really, really lovely. All these different ideas within the book there. Look, oh, that's a bunny rabbit, look. Oh, no. Beautiful. Oh, look! Now, obviously, today, you've seen Jo making a teddy bear from her own design. This is a Tilda book by Tone with all the different... And there's lots of animals in this one, aren't there? Oh, that's a nice... Oh, they're nice. Are they like Easter eggs hanging in...
They're pretty.
Oh, I might have to make some of those for Easter. Definitely. Nice. Are they ducks? Chickens? Oh, no, oh, they're swans, are they? I think they're... Oh, no, oh, I don't know. Geese! I like the one at the back, right? This is like a celebrity picture, right? They've pixelated the one at the back because she doesn't want to be seen in the picture with all the other geese. I like that. And then we've got the witches, good witches, good witches. And then, are they laughing at me? Everyone else does. Oh, there's the hare with the big ears. So, and then, tea cosy. Not enough people make tea in a pot anymore, do they? So many people just throw a tea bag in a mug, don't they? Bird house egg cosies. Oh, look, they're cute, aren't they? So using the Tilda fabrics that we've got, you could make plenty of these ideas, little bags. Oh, look, and then you've even got patterns in the back of that book. So that's £7.95 for the crafting springtime gifts. It's just... Right, very popular, very popular. Right, before we go to the next book, we're going to see what stage we're up to now. With you, this is a Joe design, this one. It'll be in Joe's book eventually.
So that's the front done and ready
loads
to go.
Oh, loads of people asking for Joe's book. I'll get her to do one, don't you worry.
Now, I'm going to sew the back together all in one, but I'm going to, in the middle section, above the tail, do some wide stitches on the widest setting on the machine so that I can sew it together, but then at the end, open that.
Pop those stitches, yeah.
Yes.
And so will you do... Oh, I'll watch. I won't preempt, I'll watch.
I'll try and make sure I get the right setting for the wide stitches.
So you do normal stitches so far down.
So to about just before the end of the head area, I would say. To about sort of here-ish in the back. Right.
So you're now doing big stitches.
Just a few big
stitches. So you're not stopping and starting, you're just doing big stitches.
No.
Right, okay. Then you'll go back to normal size stitches.
So go back to normal size stitches.
Fabulous.
And then with tail, anything that's sewn directly into... Oh, it didn't go back to normal. Anything that's sewn directly into a seam, I would go back over and over-sew just to make sure it's well held.
Oh, okay.
But
so they're like the tail.
I didn't reset the stitches as I thought I had done. I'll go back and do that.
So. Okay, then while you do that, which one of these? The Tilda Summertime book. You're not missing anything with Jo, I promise. She's just restitching that seam. This is the Tilda Summer Ideas. Now, this is not as thick a book as that last one, but again, really, really beautiful. Almost looks like fashion for dollies, that one, doesn't it, really? And that's a nice bag. That's a lovely bag, isn't it? Really love... Oh, look, they're carousel... Are they carousel horses? Let's just have a look. What's it say on there? I can't read that from here. They're a sort of horse. Darla horse? Do you know what horses?
Oh, they're Scandinavian, aren't they?
With the little legs. I always remember, very quickly, when I was on More Cushions Hearts there, and then I look at the patterns there. When we were filming at Tomb Raider out in Iceland, and they said, get four big horses, right? And there were these great big warriors, and the horses that turned up were like this big, and Angelina Jolie looked, and there were these like great big horsemen on these little like Shetland ponies like that. Right. £6.95, Hilda's Summer Ideas book. Okay, now moving on.
Okay, so the back is sewn together, but there are, I don't know, you can see there, some wide stitches that can be opened up later.
Okay.
So then one on top of the other, right sides together. I'm going to pop a few pins in and then sew around the outside. So
all the way around.
All the way around.
All the way around. Matching, I suppose you'd match the centre... And the centre, wouldn't you? Because your centre seam with your fold in the centre seam, it's going to go all the way around. Do you want to have a look at this other book while Jo does that? Yeah, so she's going to pin all the way around and then stitch literally all the way. It looks like a gingerbread man that way,
it
around,
does.
Doesn't it? Stitch all the way around. Right, now this is... Now, that's Jo's pattern, just so you know. That's Jo's own pattern. This is a Tilda book here. It's called Tilda's Studio. We showed it right at the very beginning of the show. Very, very popular. It's, like I said, it's like a almost like a coffee table book, this one, isn't it? Because it's got everything in it. Lovely pictures, lovely illustrations, lots and lots of ideas that you could then use for £14.95. That's stunning, isn't it? All the different, how to embellish. I mean, it's just lovely. It's so, and also, you might, oh, look at those strawberries. Aren't they lovely? They're cherries. The cherries on the next page, sorry. Cherries on the next page. But the thing is, what you could do is this would inspire you. Oh, now they made these the other day. I think Sammy made these the other day. In England, but she made cups like that. Really, really lovely ideas, isn't it? Gorgeous. Look at those. Really beautiful ideas. At £14.95. So there's another bag there, large bag. Really. Oh, is that an apron? Really. Oh, an ironing board cover as well. It's got everything in it, really. Toys. Oh, they're nice. Lovely, like, pretend lanterns there. So many... Oh, look. Oh, nice. Slippers. Beautiful cushions there. And again, if you go right to the back here... Oops. You've got all the glossary. You've also got the patterns. You've got all the patterns going on in the back there as well. So you trace those off so you didn't ruin the book. You could trace all of those off, couldn't you? And make your own patterns. Really lovely, at £14.95. Now, that is by Tone Finanga, who is the actual inspiration. Who is Tilda? Who is Tilda? Tilda Fabrics, very, very popular, fabulous quality. But books as well, really, really lovely books there. So how are you getting on going around the edge of that one?
Not doing too badly. Over halfway.
How many minutes? Oh, I've got about 4 minutes. We're all right.
Oh, right.
Oh, we've got 2 minutes now. Remember, we've had this... I mean, if you've missed anything today, by the way, you can always go to YouTube and watch any of the shows right from the beginning, right from when we launched on the 31st of January. They're all there on the YouTube. Do you reinforce any of the stitches, or you just go round? You don't go backwards and forwards anyway, you just go all the way
around?
Only
the beginning and the end. And I will reinforce any limbs or ears or things that are joined into a seam. Just so they don't
get pulled. Where the ears are sewn in there, you'll just go over those like you did with the tail earlier.
I will. I won't do that right now. I'll just get straight onto the clipping. I've done this quite speedily, so the stitching might not be great. There you go. We want to clip the internal corners, either side of the...
Now, remember, if you've got any questions you need to ask, you can email in, you can ring the call centre at any time. If we don't get straight back to you, we will get back to you within 2 days with answers to your questions. Now, I'm back again tomorrow with more guests, so please, please join me at 8 o'clock tomorrow. As I say, if you missed out on anything today, you can watch on YouTube... search for Sewing Quarter and they'll come up, and there's all the shows all the way. They're all individual shows all the way from the beginning. We started on the 31st of January. Now you're just clipping around around all the curves.
I am.
This is fantastic because it can inspire you to make so many different kind of animals. Remember, the fabric we've used, gorgeous, gorgeous fabric, is the cherry blossom. The teal was the green. It came in pink and it came in blue as well. A really, really fabulous, fabulous fabric. Good quality. And you know how gorgeous the bumblebee ranges by Tilda are. So, that's us done, I think, Jo.
That's done.
Yeah. Are you going to bag in 3 days to extra?
Shall I?
Oh, yes, you've got to split the stitches, haven't you? And then just stuff in with toy filling. And then would you just hand stitch up the back there?
I would. With ladder stitch, it tends to be the way I close everything. Take care when doing the clipping not to catch any quilt lines. I would clip slightly around the curve of the face as well, but I'll turn him out quickly.
Right. So as you turn that through, we'll just say a very big thank you for watching today. I hope you've had a lovely time. I've really enjoyed myself today. As I say, I'll be back. You're not in tomorrow, are you?
I am in tomorrow.
Oh, we'll see you tomorrow. Take care. Have a lovely day.
Did you know there are multiple ways you can contact us, even if it's just to ask a question? Our friendly team are always on standby. You can call our customer service team at 0800 112 4433, email us at help@sewingquarter.com, visit our Facebook page, follow us on Instagram, Follow us on Twitter at Sewing Quarter and even message us through our website, and our presenters will answer your questions live on air.